Saturday Night Virus begins now.
This is as disorganized as it comes.
Women's power is in your fear of whatever they're going to do.
Black Phillip.
Fat-tongued mongoloid.
Love, doctor.
I told my girl she's the fourth most important thing in my life.
So sensitive.
It was me, my career,
family,
my mother, and then her.
Smooth as silk.
She only thinks she knows shit because I tell her shit.
Oh, wow. Keeping your pimp strong.
I think my girl in my life is worth five bitches now.
I should have went with I Feel Love like I wanted.
Change that to I Feel Love, motherfucker. Listening to Danny and his producer. Yeah. This is a fucking... Yeah, I'm sorry, Danny.
It's all right.
This is just an ingenious way of saying I want some ass. Thank you, Billy. Oh. Wait, I gotta hear the words. I gotta let some pre-cum come out. Remember this? You know when she this fucking thing? Oh, remember, go to YouTube, Donna Summer Live. It's so good, it's so good. And she just... And this song ain't shit. She just... Look at what it makes girls do. Look at it. Look at those soggy tits moving. Look at that. That motherfucker is almost firm now. She got the sweat patch on her sweater. See what this song does? Go to YouTube and watch this. If you don't want to fuck when you hear this song, you are either retarded or gay and you don't need music to fuck.
He's just horny.
Or you're an asshole. Oh, and she's just pumping in and out. No disrespect to Barry White. Just I feel like a little Donna Summer. When she was young and delicious. Your hair looks a little Donna Summer.
I'm a little Donna Summer tonight.
Yeah.
That's why I thought it was a good idea for the theme song.
I bet her titties are sweating on me. Kara looks like she got her titties get hot. I fucking love this song. I could hear this whole fucking thing. Oh, man. Well, all right, Bill. I guess we got to get it going, man. I could just listen to this song all fucking day. Welcome to the Black Phillip Show. I am not Black Phillip. That is the name of the show. And I apologize, everybody who's fucking stuck. When was the last time we was on a fucking month ago, Dan?
About that.
Yeah. And I apologize. I do apologize, but I got fucking what you would call it. It's like a pseudo-career. I do run around from time to time. I wish I could be here more often for you folks. I know you're dealing with... First of all, I know you need us this week, because it's soon to be that horseshit holiday.
It is not.
That you got to deal with. Hold on, can I introduce you, rambunctious? But she got big titties, though. God damn, titties are fucking humongous. Ladies and gentlemen, listen, before we get it, those who've heard the fucking show before know what this is. This is the Black Phillip Show, and basically, I'm Patrice O'Neill. Some people call Black Phillip, but it's the show. It's an advice show if you're having a little trouble with your bitch. And to be honest, if you're having trouble with your boyfriends, which ends up really... Coming back to trouble with your bitch. Because that's redundant. Bitches don't have trouble with guys. We have one problem. We like to fuck strange. Get over it. I mean, it is. I'll explain it to you. It's very easy. We like strange pussy. But basically, we're trying to help fellas get through this nonsense, man. You understand? So let me introduce you to my co-host here, Mr. Dante Reginald Nero. Good friend
on,
of mine.
Everybody? Yeah.
Comedian extraordinaire.
I don't know about that.
Big tattooed up nigga.
Yeah.
Bitches love him. Ex-pimp. Ex-stripper.
All that.
Ex-husband.
All that.
Nigga,
no.
Just a lot of exes. It's a rap. Just keeping around just for
pussy.
Yeah, keeping around for some ass, some ex-wife ass,
side,
and some
side ass.
And for financial reasons and shit. You know what I mean?
Get
also up. Joining us is the lovely Drew Boogie, who comes in because he's an undercover woman hater.
So he lives
through me because Drew Boogie, he's one of these nice guys who fucking live vicariously through assholes and go, yeah, get him. So I get shot in the head, but he goes, oh, yeah.
Dang,
you know, Patrice
awful.
Went too far there. It's just awful.
Absolutely not.
And we have the lovely Danny and Bill. Billy here from the ONA show helping us out, man, who I love. Let me give you the phone number really quick, and then we're going to introduce you to someone special.
Aww.
Okay, now hold on a second. The number is 866. Wait a minute. Niggas is already calling because they know I don't
lift phones already.
Because I don't get to call this.
Waiting for us to come on.
I'm sorry, everybody. I'm going to get to more calls, I swear on my soul.
You say that every
this
show.
This motherfucker has already been waiting for 5 minutes. I'm sorry. I'm the most not getting to a call, over-talking motherfucker I've ever heard, and I can't get over it. This motherfucker's like, all right, and go. We got a call right now. Help, man. My girl tried to rape me. I swear to God, we got to get to it. I'm sorry.
Oh,
I'll get the number out, though. It's 866-WOW1-WOW. I hope I don't have to tell you to add a 1 if you're not on the cell phone. 866-WOW1-WOW, which is 866-969-1969. And do we have a drum roll for the... Do we have our own theme music for this lovely young lady?
Yeah.
What's your theme music, Patrice? You got a song you like?
You're going to laugh at me, though.
No, go ahead.
Oh, okay, I got one. DeBarge. Special Love Me in a Special Way.
Do you have Love Me in a Special Way by DeBarge?
I will try and find it.
If Danny can't do it, it can't be done. We're going to give her a special introduction. Because you do remember... We had a lovely lady named Kathleen Roll that joined us in the first couple of days. Now, I don't want to trash her, man. No. You heard her. I wanted to be with her. I love her. I'm telling you, not some people you fucking love and you get them in a certain situation.
It's like
and
a drunk, like,
they like
a drunk
Rex,
uncle.
Rex Grossman is going to be this Sunday. Just going to flub. You know, just as a human being. She was so intelligent, so... quirky, so funny, but she needed pills. She needed a pill, and she was a little nutty, and I mean officially. You know, you get a bitch like the Runaway Bride. You ever see her eyes? That's Kathleen. You ever see a motherfucker? You ever see a motherfucker that can't blink? The bitch is born without blinking glands. And if this bitch don't work out, we're going to talk about you behind your back like a fucking dog, too, ho. So.
You talk about me in front of me. Like, you talk about me behind my back is going to hurt my feelings.
I wish Kathleen was here so I could trash and tell her why she. And she didn't get fired because she didn't get paid, so I guess She just faded away. She got. You can't get fired. She was a volunteer. That's like a motherfucker coming in volunteering.
The old radio bitches just fade away.
You know it's bad when you got to get rid of a volunteer.
All right, wait, here's my part.
This lonely shit. This fucking low self-esteem song, like, this is her looking in the mirror, crying, going, I'm a good person.
You are such a dick.
I'm a good person.
A dick.
I deserve the best. She holds her own, like she squishes
her own titties.
She squeezes her shoulders together, and she hugs herself.
I'm a good person.
Ladies and gentlemen, all right, turn this horse shit off. Motherfucking DeBarge, natural cherry curls. You know what,
I want a
you
song.
You know what? Ladies and gentlemen, we got to get Dante Nero song.
You got Jungle Fever? Jungle's hot. You know
but,
what?
He's
a
jungle.
No, not that.
Jungle Boogie. The old one.
Jungle Boogie.
No, it's called Jungle Fever. It's old.
By who?
Yeah, who?
Oh, that obscure shit. This nigga didn't say nothing. No. Like, give it to me, baby, and written
boom,
by Rick Drake.
Boom, 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 boom. And it's got a Spanish chick in the background moaning.
Oh, no, you know what that is? That's not, that's called
Jungle Fever. That's the song.
Yeah, okay, do you see the blank stare on Danny's face? Do you see the blank stare on his face?
Go to the soundtrack of Boogie Nights. Go to the soundtrack of Boogie Nights.
Can you say my name, please?
I will, bitch. Hold on. We don't do this according to you.
But you played my theme song.
This is the Black Carrot
Dante
show.
Dante is infinitely more important than you, that we get his theme song worked out.
Plus, I'm a guy. Just because he has a penis.
We didn't even give this other crazy bitch
exactly
a fucking
right.
theme song. How dare you?
She's crazy.
Pushy motherfucker, are you actually out of her mind? I didn't even give a person who was on three shows a fucking theme song. I'm just now giving Dante a theme song.
That's right.
Wait a minute. We'll get back to your shitty theme song. You're a goddamn... Drew Boogie's been to three shows before you.
Yeah,
Drew Boogie makes his own theme song.
He brings a new one.
He can make his
changes
own.
Changes it.
Drew will have his own.
That's this is the one.
Yeah.
And when I say the name, that's the... Why is this your song?
Watch.
Oh, because, okay, I get it.
I can feel it.
Ah, that's the shit. She's getting the business.
Alright, that's your theme song.
That's my theme song.
Alright, cut that shit off. That's not that theme song. Ain't that, what is that called? It's called Jungle Boogie.
Jungle Fever.
It's called Jungle Fever.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yay.
Well, we have to reintroduce. All right, let's do it over again. How long has the show been on? Oh, it's only been on 10 minutes. We got till 12.
You only got
all right, ready?
On
ladies
hold
and gentlemen, we're
going
to start it all over again. We're starting the show all over again. So relax. You start with my shit first. I feel love, Bill. Let's do this. This is now the intro of the show from now on. Drew Boogie brings your own music.
Yes, I will.
Every time we're on, you'll bring your own whatever you created.
I shall.
Some boogie shit.
That's right.
You want some
new out of.
If people wonder why Drew Boogie's here, Drew Boogie was here from the inception of
the
finding out
idea.
That girls bug me to no end. Is the fact that he was here, out of nowhere, you just turn your back and you're just like, why is Drew here? Like, he can't stand bitches. Drew can't stand them.
Really?
But he cannot stand. Why?
Because
he's
just sweet.
Because
he's not sweet.
He's a hunk of shit. Drew probably.
He's an
Drew probably has a couple
guy.
Of rape cases pending, a fucking murder beef, a couple of bitches tied up in his basement.
As we speak.
He probably has it tied up and has the turntables on top of their head as he's mixing. Drew got an evil streak.
And he got a relationship face.
And he had girls always never believed Drew was fucked up. And so that's why Drew is here. He was a quiet, minion in terms of just girls bug him. And now he's just here and he's Drew and he's fucking here and he's part of the show. We started off, we're going to welcome you back to the Black Phillip Show.
Start it over.
Welcome you back to the Black Phillip Show. Come on, man. Come on, Bill. Yes. And we gotta figure it out.
Should I introduce you? Let me introduce you.
This is my theme music. This is my theme music.
Absolutely.
And I'm gonna introduce you all to the Black Phillip Relations Show. Again, I am not Black Phillip, nigga. It's just a mockery of another Phillip motherfucker. We are here to try our best between me, Dante, and our lovely co-host that we'll get to when we get to. Because I want people to understand that this ain't hatred towards women. This is helping you hoes. It's a term of endearment. Let me explain to you why I say hoeing, bitch. It's not just frivolous nonsense. It's just to let you know that you are at my mercy on whether I say it to you or not. You don't just get to have me go, hey, you're not a bitch because you don't want me to call you one. It's because I don't feel like it. That's what I'm letting you know. That anything that comes out of my mouth with respect is because you earn it and I feel like giving it to you. And I desire not to call you a bitch. You don't just get it because that you don't call me no bitch. Why don't you open the door? Why don't you put down a good jacket over that puddle? Fuck that. Now we're going to introduce our... Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to introduce you to my good friend and co-host of the Black Phillip Show. Okay, we got to get this right, Danny. Nigga, he has his own theme music. It's all right. We're going to figure this shit out.
Start it over again.
You know this is a bi-monthly show, nigga. We can't...
Start it over again. You're figuring out the show on the air.
What these niggas doing? You've been fucked up with your girlfriend for the last month. Wait another 10 minutes while I get this show together. We come in, all of a sudden you're in a rush to make your life better. So we have to seamlessly go into Jungle Fever.
Yeah,
we gotta find some way. We go, and we here, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, indeed.
Yeah.
Keeping the flow going. You see how the energy's still fucking energy? Yeah. You notice whose song brings it all down into I love myself. Poor shit. The co-host with the most? I don't know. Fucking rapper.
Yeah.
Yes.
I know you're mad because of styling on you. Oh, you mad because of styling on you. Big man, all tatted up, light skin, bald motherfucker, bones in his ears, all type of shit going on. Skull, earrings, all type of evil shit, but he's a nice guy. But he also knock you out. Wife is fine as shit, but he's separated from her right now, which is a good thing for him. But I'm not separated from my girl, so he can't come over to my house if we have the orgy we want.
We trying, though.
Because the timing of our goodness to a bitch at the same time is just not melding. But it'll happen, nigga.
We gonna put a hit out on your girl.
Please, give a big quiet radio applause for the lovely and talented Dante.
Yeah.
Reginald Nero.
What's going on? What's going on?
Brother.
And we have the DJ, Superior DJ Supreme, who fucking on the low hates bitches. On the low! Without theme music, because he's going to bring his own. You just fucking stick in some Drew Boogie shit. The nigga's going to do it. Give it up for Drew Boogie, y'all.
Thank you, y'all. Thank
Drew.
You.
And yeah, now, hopefully... hopefully...
This is a message to you. You need to listen to this.
Love you in a special way or love myself in a special way?
Love is soggy.
Love me in a special way.
You gotta earn it. Who are you? I know you like that. You deserve. She has big Donna Summer hair.
I do.
She has this cute, she has a cute little face.
And Shaka Khan titties.
Big, juicy, soggy titties.
Soggy?
Deliciously soggy. Oh, my God. I know the areolas look like two boxing gloves.
Oh, my God.
But they look like the nipple is flat, like one of them nipples that don't get hard.
What's wrong with you?
Yeah, flick it.
Are you hot?
Look like two CD cases.
You, I can't believe you.
They
you're not even listening to
beautifully
this
soggy. Wait. Welcome to the show. I say titty extraordinaire.
Titty extraordinaire is good.
Intelligence extraordinaire.
Absolutely.
Ethic extraordinaire. Only thing I can't say extraordinaire is comic. Which she wants me to say. I just can't do it. But
you're gonna get struck by lightning one time after the show.
The lovely, talented Karis Foster, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
Welcome,
Karis.
She's a black girl. You won't be able to tell while she's talking. But it doesn't matter because she hates niggas. She will not date a nigger. This bitch will date third world Russians. Date Chinese midgets.
Armenians.
She'll date uncircumcised.
Armenian.
An uncircumcised Armenian. Before she will date a nigga.
They're dying out. They're dying out. The Armenians
she
are dying
will
out.
Like, well, you better get to your last one, nigga. Niggas is dying out too, bitch.
That is not true.
Holy shit.
That's not true. And why must you always use the N-words? Do you know they're trying to illegalize that in New York now?
We know.
Well, I'm just letting you know. You're not following along.
They didn't make that shit a... Anyway, shut the fuck up.
Here's my point. You see how she immediately sucked the energy out of the room?
Exactly.
I didn't suck anything for 19 minutes.
Everybody's going, know they're trying to illegalize, which is not a word, Miss fucking Condoleezza Rice. It's not illegalizing a word, but
they're trying to make illegal. Whatever. That's not the point.
But ladies and gentlemen, Karis Foster,
yes,
who is very opinionated about relationships, and she's one of these bitches who go on at everything.
That is
if
not
somebody's
true.
Constipated, she'll go, oh, you know,
well,
you should try some liquid. And you'll be shitting. But she'll whisper shitting.
And you'll be shitting.
She don't say it out loud.
You'll be shitting.
Since I am a lady and I have class.
She don't say shitting. Movement.
You'll be doing that out the number. Soon. In no time. I don't want to say shitting.
You see how she tried to change it to an intelligent. You know, they're trying to legalize shit. We all fucking know and no one cares. We want some ass. Every Saturday, when Black Phillip on, it's about making your ass day.
Can I ask you a question? Okay, why you about to, like, you're talking about Valentine's Day coming up and calling the most horrible, awful, like, what? Why? Why? It's about love. Love is awesome.
Oh, boy.
Is he going to hit me now?
Oh, boy. We just teach him. This is a testimony of why you need a strong woman in the room. Mm. You got to have it. Because bitches will try to change the mood into what they want. So she goes, hey, you sit down with that Valentine's Day. We'll get to that when we
all
need
right,
to.
Okay.
Good girl.
Mm. Hey, no. Don't even good girl me like that. I am not a submissive. I'm not one of your little submissive
girlfriends.
That's
why you got that big weave in your hair so I can grab it and tear you around this room.
Look at her face. Oh, God. I've got some sexy titties. Look at her.
Oh. Ew,
that's
what
exactly the reaction you were looking for.
I know, you know what? I knew he was going for that. So, you know, I'm not going to give that to you anymore, ever.
Really?
Oh,
yes,
will.
You are.
Yeah, you
yeah,
will.
You
yeah,
can't
you
help
will.
It.
No, I won't. No, I won't. You
I got level.
I'm going to put my coat back on.
I go to level.
I'm going to put my coat back on.
They already in my jerk file, baby. You can put on... You can wear a motherfucker around you. You want to talk about stuff? Karen, we're gonna. Don't you worry, sweetie. You're gonna figure it out.
I'm following your lead. I am following your lead. I know this is not the Kareth Foster show. This is the Patrice.
Oh, it certainly ain't
show.
The Kareth Foster.
I know that, and I know that.
I never heard it.
Stop.
I know it was awful. Anybody listen to Sirius Radio from time to time?
Are you allowed
show
to say that on that?
Yeah, you can say Sirius. Yeah, you can.
All right.
Fucking, this is not. Fucking
I had a great show.
Ugh.
It was.
Had.
It well, it's not. Whatever.
Exactly.
We're not going there.
That's
shut up.
Exactly.
Shut
past
up.
Tense. Thank you, Danny.
No,
you
it's
had.
Not past tense.
Because you had a bunch of girl power shit on there. I know you.
Because women are fucking funny. Women are funny.
Does funny have a synonym?
Okay, peanut gallery.
Mm. All right, look, women.
Women are funny.
All right.
Not bitches and hoes aren't funny. But
bitches and hoes are hilarious.
That's funny.
But women are never funny. I'll tell you why. Breasts ain't funny, but titty is hilarious. Vagina ain't funny, but pussy, coochie, that's some funny shit. Tata, lemon slice.
Gash.
Gash.
Oh, my God, that is disgusting.
Hatch a nappy dugout. Nappy dugout is hilarious.
Hilarious. But anything with self-esteem is not funny. That's why guys have to run from you. Because if we say pussy, you'll go, oh, my God. Then we have to turn it into vagina.
No, vagina is not a sexy word. That's why I call mine Julie. What?
For what?
Because when you hear the name Julie, don't you think fun, friendly, warm, maybe a little fuzzy?
No, why don't you call it...
Think whiter than white.
Fuck box.
You know, we love you call it smushy, gushy, nasty mess, and we go, delicious. Julie means you love it. Julie means
I do love it.
Love me. Do you take your pussy and, like, move it so it's singing that song?
No, but I'm going to now.
Love me. There's no way.
Yeah, fucking, mock me, but you know the fucking song.
And she does it with the asshole, dude. Love me, man. Oh, shit. Oh, Karen. Again, listen, man, just accept Karen. I accept her for who she is. She's a hard-headed black woman who's been around. She's from Texas, now residing in Manhattan. She's self-made.
Yeah.
You know, good credit, one of them bitches.
Independent.
She's independent. She don't play around.
That's right.
So that's why she's here. We don't want any girls easily bullied here. Because there's a lot of dumb ones that would just go, okay. You know, Karis is somebody, like I always say, you need to battle women's emotions with your logic. Some women are so emotional, right, that you need, like, different levels of logic. Like, when I first met my girl, she was goofy. She only needed... one drop of logic, and I would give her two, just so she'd go, okay,
keep it.
B, beat her down. Now the bitch knows me. I got to give her 47 levels of logic while she still gives me the same one level of emotion. She just uses the fact that she knows I'm going to use logic when I'm talking to her to combat that shit, but still have the same emotion that she had coming in. So I'm talking to her, and okay, here's my thing. I tell this motherfucker, I say, look, don't ask me a question first when you ultimately want something from me. Don't walk in the room and say, what you doing later? Then that makes me want to lie. That makes me go, oh, shit.
I don't know what's going on.
I'm going to the moon. Right? Then she goes, oh, because I was going to suck your balls later.
Fuck. I'm not going to the moon.
Fuck. But now you can't say I'm not going to the moon because she goes, you were lying. You understand what I'm saying?
Right.
When you want something, you come in and go, listen, I was thinking about sucking your balls. Are you going to be busy later? You tell me what the fuck you want first, bitch. Now, I'm sitting there for an hour and 10 minutes trying to
figure out
my way to her, trying to let her know why that puts me in a bad fucking spot to have to. It puts it on me.
But wait.
What?
How about just not fucking lying when she asks you what you're doing later?
Do you understand? Do you see?
That's logical. You just answered your own.
Do you see why? It's like even the smart ones don't fucking get it.
No, because
why would
like,
I? No. Wait. Why the fuck?
Right.
Let me tell you what it is. You don't like sweet talk.
It's passive aggressive.
It's passive aggressive, and you know what else it is? It's because you're.
But if you already know.
Wait a minute. You're not tuned in to rejection. I'm gonna explain it to you again, and then let you talk. You're not tuned into rejection from a man on a daily basis. Meaning this, if you go, can I want this, right? Mm-hmm. What's wrong with coming to me saying, I would like you to do this for me? And you know why you don't do that? It leaves too much open for me to go no and for you to be rejected. But if you ask, if you put it on me, what are you doing later? Nothing. Okay, if you're not doing nothing, you think we can go to the movies? Now, I might want to do nothing and not go to the motherfucking movie.
I just say, honey, I don't want to go.
Do you think it's that simple? Are you out your mind?
Hey, sweetheart,
it's that simple for me.
Offer another suggestion. Well, okay, first of all, wait a second. I am all about open communication, okay? Do not get me wrong. I understand what you're saying, and I totally appreciate it. As a girl, as a woman.
Will you fucking just get it out?
All right, no, my fucking point is this, Patricia. You're making me curse.
There you go.
I don't like
we're bringing out what you really are. First of all, wait a minute. Keep that thought. And this is perfect. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, this is why we need a woman on the show to let you know that this is, even though you're super smart, this is the shit you do. You gotta preface it with something that we don't want to hear first.
You know what's funny
but
is when you said that,
like that,
when you said that, it clicked in her head, and then she went to level two. How can I combat what you said in the first place?
No, it's not about combating. I am agreeing with him. I agree. We should be communicating better. But however, if you already know that your woman is going to do that, then like you're already one step ahead. You're saying you know she does this all the time. If it's a tactic,
why the fuck am I supposed to
accommodate?
You're an equal part of the relationship, are you not?
Fucks no. I lead the relationship.
Oh my
God. How the fuck can you have a 50-50 relationship?
Oh my God. Okay. Well, you know what? You can take turns.
Wait, no.
You can take turns.
Watch your fucking mind.
Why can't
you? No, you can't. Because you don't have the ability to lead.
Me? I don't have the ability.
As a woman, you don't have the ability to lead.
Are you shitting me?
No, absolutely not.
Where are you going to lead me to?
Wherever I want you to go.
Exactly. What suggestion do you have?
For what? For going anywhere?
For anything. Do you think... Ready? Hold on. Ready? Do you think men should call women bitches?
It depends on the situation.
Do you think men should call women bitches?
It depends on the situation.
Frivolously. Should I just say, hey, bitch?
Not if you don't know somebody.
Why not?
Because you don't know them. You don't know if they're a bitch or not.
Really? That's a good enough answer for you?
Yeah, it is.
It's not. You know why? You gave me no reason. You just said...
Because it's wrong and disrespectful.
No, it's
and
not.
You don't even know
that's
this
just
person.
How you feel.
That's like, should I go up and say, hey,
wait
asshole.
Wait a minute. I told you...
Hey, asshole.
I told you why...
Hey, asshole.
I say bitch. You're not giving me a reason
saying,
why I shouldn't.
Because you don't know
I'm
if they don't
you,
deserve your respect. You're going in there assuming. You're going in there assuming that they don't deserve your respect
why
or attention.
Why is bitch a disrespectful term?
Because of how it's used.
Why?
That makes it disrespectful.
Don't women automatically expect men to respect them?
No, they don't automatically. Because if they did automatically, women would treat themselves better. Than they do, and they would act more accordingly.
What are you talking about?
I don't understand
about?
What that. I don't. I don't know.
There are a lot of women who have self-esteem issues.
Do you hear that? Hey, all of you have self-esteem issues.
No, not all of us do.
That's why you're not good at the leading thing. You're good soldiers. You're not good generals. You don't want to be in charge. Here's what you want to be. You want to constantly test to see if this person. You ever see that movie, Master and Commander? The shit with Russell Crowe?
And Paul Bettany.
Yes. And the guy is walking around, Russell Crowe's second in command is walking around the ship, right? And he's trying to be friendly with the motherfucking, with the mates.
With the crew.
Yeah.
And they're looking at him like, this pussy ass nigga. Okay. Now, Russell Crowe snatches this guy. First of all, Russell Crowe said, he saw the two guys looking at him funny. Uh-huh. He goes, put them up against the mask and give them that cat and nine tails.
Right.
Fuck him up.
Right.
And he had to go and call this guy and go, look, let me tell you something, man.
These dudes
are not your friends. They are looking for someone to lead them, but they want to be led by somebody that they believe in. Mm. That's a woman. Women want to look at a guy and believe that he will lead them where they need to go. But they're going to test him like he's a weak-ass second mate. And if this motherfucker goes, I'm going to just be your friend, you're going to disrespect him. That's the nature of the game. In every single part of the world, on every single level, the bitch version of an animal is weaker than a fucking man version. Except for praying mantises and men.
And black widows.
Yeah, go down to spiders that I can smash with my feet anyway. I'll step on either one of them motherfuckers. How about that? So, other than a couple of insects.
So, what about seahorses when the guys get pregnant?
Exactly. That's what they have to do. This is where a smart bitch comes in because she knows what I'm fucking. What about dung beetles? The women dung beetles don't push shit around. Goofy-o. That's what they do. This is what I'm saying, fellas. Do you see what Kaz is doing? This is what your girlfriend does. And you have to. Let me tell you something about
let
that.
It deflect.
Don't lose the war.
Exactly.
Hey, I can lose a battle, but win the war. Don't concede a battle.
Women do like
you women. Fucking win battles. Every single, no matter how little it is, no matter how insignificant you think it is, you fight
and
so that the bitch adds an option to her life. Okay, give you another thing. Give you another story about my girl found an option. And this is how your girl will find an option. When she starts opening her fucking mouth. Yesterday,
my girl
don't open her fucking mouth anymore. When she can't, that old saying, don't let your mouth write a check, your ass can't cash. You understand? So this big black bitch at at GameStop. I'm sitting there talking to them. You know, if at GameStop, there's only one goofy-ass motherfucker who's taking care of a whole store full of geeks, and he is slow, and he's an asshole. And when you get to him, you wanna develop a relationship with this nigga. So I'm talking to him, and this motherfucker's like, oh, yeah, and I'm gonna go, what about Gears of War? What about this? What about that? What you think of this? What's new? What have you heard about this? I bought some new shit, World War II battle thing with planes and boats and shit. So he's like, oh, and this big black, all this chit chat, all this, what's all this? With nobody there to stop me from punching her in her fucking mouth, except for social contract. The fact is that she believes that socially I can't knock her in her fucking mouth. But if I was had a screw loose, I could turn around and wring this bitch's neck just for that. Now, my girl did that shit talking to some motherfucker, and she's in his face like, let me tell you something. I walked away. She goes, whoa. She runs up to me, right? And goes, why would you do that? Well, why would you run? You know, he could have, he could have what? They could have what?
Why do it?
Now she has an option. That dude could have punched you in your fucking face. And you couldn't do shit about it except for look at me. So you're going to have to learn respect. It trickles down from me.
Anger,
you have to have anger.
No, you don't.
Then shut up. And I'm going to tell you something. That little trick you're doing now,
that's
level two. I've already been that disregarding. God, calm down, Mr. Angry. He's so angry. All guys are angry like that, Carol, because you're asshole. Not just you, your people.
your
phylum. You have to fucking deal with it because you want to get inside of us. You do.
Who gives a fuck?
Apparently you do.
Wait a minute. I don't want to get inside my girl no more. I've been, you know how many different ways we fuck? I use that Febreze bottle. We're despicable people. I don't have to get pussy from my girl. I put up with it because I love the bitch.
Do the wheels scenario.
I'm going to do that later. Yeah. I got to get to a couple of
33
motherfuckers.
33 minutes.
You know what?
You're right.
We got to get to a couple of motherfuckers. Matter of fact, we're going to take just a teeny break, quick break, and I swear to you, we're getting right back to always a friend to girls, Phil. We're getting right back to Phil. Going to take calls when we come back, all right? We'll see y'all in a minute.
On the Black Phillip Show, Patrice O'Neill gets to the bottom of those tough relationship issues.
Who had the herpes?
It's Black Phillip with Patrice O'Neill.
The most get some ass. It's like that makes you want to fuck.
Sex.
I'm with sex.
Is that a sex?
No, it is. It's
what is that playing
it's
out of? That
trumpet.
Shit is
it's
dope
both.
Though.
It's both.
Do you hear that? Like that's just like it makes you animal. Like you like what's up, baby? Like you know it makes you feel like a pimp. It's a pimp. Like how you feeling, baby? Good. What you doing by yourself? Are you taking? Are you taking? Well, then they go, no. And then they go, well, can I take you? Yeah. And that deserves a trumpet, nigga. Good song, Bill. Fuck you know about this shit.
No, fuck that. I picked all these.
That's you? Yeah. Oh, I thought it was Bill. I'm going to give this fucking mass murderer credit. Sorry, Bill. Thought I was doing them. Daddy,
I do my research when I'm picking the music for your show.
Your fucking hair is definitely not just black.
Did you see his hair?
It's not just your hair that's black. You fucking got a little soul, dude.
That's subject to debate, I suppose.
Fuck that. So we're back, man. Welcome back to the Black Phillip Show. See why? I think I choose people wisely, man. I don't have to explain to you why I ask people to come through. Boogie just. I want to chose, but I think Boogie chose.
I think he chose you.
He just said, fuck it.
Boogie chose a pimp.
It was, what's the movie where the guy just was just there? And the motherfucker said, all right, here, fuck it, get a gun. Here, take the gun. And it's like, you just, like all of a sudden, just Boogie's a soldier. But Carith, she's just full of dignity. See if we can get out of that. That's nonsense.
You will not break me.
See, but you just kept getting around and just pull a titty out because we wore out.
I give up.
All right, here's a fucking tick. All right? Is that what you want, titty? I didn't want to put... Carith, I heard that show you did. Mommy, I didn't want to put a king.
And you've met my mother.
Oh, Carith's mom is a real dirtbag, too.
Oh, my God, Patrice.
Carith's mom was a 79. She fucking... fuck everybody. I didn't say Carith's mom is a hoe, but she's crazy. Very...
My mom has been with my dad for 40 years.
Yeah, she still talks about sex.
Yeah,
she's
cool
one of those
like that.
Women, those
she's
mothers
cool
that
like
embarrass...
That.
She's one of those mothers that was her daughter and tries to get a daughter and goes, look, stop being me. You know what I'm saying? Because how old are you now, Kev? What, 38?
What? Are you crazy?
You look good for 38.
Do not do that to the public.
How old are you? How old are you?
I'm not telling you.
38?
No. All right. I'm between 26 and 32.
Oh, you don't look too good. You look good for 38.
No,
though.
You know what? This is what they're going to tell you. Fuck you.
You should have said 38. I'm just joking.
See, these people are going to be like, what is this? See, they can, tell
I'm
them, can you tell them how they can see what I look like? Because I'm sure they don't believe I'm black.
What, CarithFoster.com?
No, just Carith.com.
Carith.com?
Yeah.
How'd you get that?
How many Cariths do you know?
C-A-R-R-I-T-H. K-A-R-R-I-T-H.com. You got a little plug-in.
K-A-R.
Is anything showing your titties?
No. Well, titties. Not like,
she
really.
Think about it, though.
Well, no, just because, I mean, you can see them, obviously, in whatever I wear.
They're delicious. Absolutely. They're National Geographic type shit.
You see her titties through a goose down.
imagine National Geographic, but if the bitches had bras. If somebody gave them bitches a push-up bra, how much titty meat would be up in the air?
Titty meat? Can you be any grosser?
Tarith, you know what Tarith is? She's one of them black girls that if you saw, you'd be thinking, she go, oh, let me tell you something, sucker. But she opens her mouth, and it's just this little kitty voice, and it's just like... So she gives you the comfort of a white woman, where white woman ain't scary, but she gives you the big old titties of a black woman.
The sass of a black
woman. The sass and the ass. And uh-huh. I bet you Kara fucks with an uh-huh.
What?
I bet you turn into uh-huh, bitch, when you fuck. Uh-huh, let me tell you something, sucker. You call that a dick? play the music from San Francisco. Wah, 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 wah. That's how she fucked. Come here, you big dummy.
You
let me
so
sit
retarded.
On your dick.
You are so retarded.
Let me sit on your dick, big dummy. Come here. Come here, old man. I heard you think you can fuck.
No,
let me tell you something about your dick. Take your dick, put it in my pocket, sit down it. Ellen. Give me that big dick. You call that a dick, you fish eye fool. Now that's a dick. Glory, that's a dick. You call that one? I'll stick your dick in some gorilla cookies. Oh no, some dough. I'll stick your dick in some dough and make some gorilla cookies, you big dummy. Bend me over, pull my hair. That's right. This is right when she comes. Now get out, you big dummy. and take that broken plate with you out the junkyard. Fucking always trying to be Mrs. fucking Barack Obama all the fucking time. I gotta take these calls, man. I'm sorry. Let me get to these fucking calls a little bit. I'm sorry, y'all. We just breaking on old fucking crazy ass Karen. Hey, we gotta go. Hey, Phil, I'm getting you next, but I gotta go to Randy from Texas, man. Randy, you there?
Yeah, I am.
Sorry to leave you holding so long, dude, but I appreciate you calling, man. What's going on?
Hey, I wasn't going anywhere anyway. But
thank you,
Patrice,
sir.
I just got to tell you, you are my savior. You're a god.
Fucking hell, that's there was a time. There was a time when my self-esteem was too low to take that compliment. But thank you, sir. A full god. Thank you, sir. Why is that, man?
Well, I got XM like a year and a half ago and started listening to ONA, and then when I heard about your show back in April, I listened. And mm-hmm. I've listened to everyone since then, and I was in like a rut, and I got this epiphany through you of talking about losing ego and just being straightforward, don't lie, you know, and stuff like that. Just tell them who you are. And I've gotten laid more in the past 6 months than I have in 3 years.
All right, Phil.
But I have discovered one thing. There are some women that can't handle it.
Well, that's the whole thing, sir. The thing is, it's something you call, like I said, it's from this movie War Games. It's you got to watch this game. There's two principles to this. One principle is you cannot. It's whose happiness is more important. That's the game you play. Whose happiness is more important first? That's
mine.
The game. Yours. Second
mine.
Principle is from this movie War Games, where the part
the only
where
way to win is not to play.
The only way to win. Strange game, Professor Falcon. The only winning move is not to play. Now, if the bitch don't want to play your game, you don't play. That's all it is. My happiness is the game. So if I feel something, if you feel something, that means it's valid. If I feel it in my gut, that means there's something going on. So if I'm going to fucking say it. I'm not going to bite my tongue. I'm going to tell you how I feel. Okay, sweetie, I'm not taking you out on another date. I've been on 3 dates with you. I know I want to fuck you. I don't know if you want to fuck me, but I already know I want to fuck you. If you don't want to fuck me, figure it out. But we're not going on any more food excursions, so I can do something for you, and you're not doing shit for me.
What about the whole courting process? Like, Randy, I'm glad for you.
The courting process of who? Who needs the courting process? Me or you?
Well, I think everybody does.
No.
Both.
Tarith, you're shitting.
Because it
you're
builds
shitting.
Up. It builds up to this, like, great, almost like building up.
No, it builds up for you.
But
We will fuck you today.
Randy, we don't have to take you to dinner. Let me ask you a question. And this is for any guy listening. Do you have your girl, if she's with you and all that shit, you can look forward and don't have to look in the eye. But did you have to like her to fuck her? Did you have to like your woman before you fucked her? Matter of fact, if you don't like a bitch that much before you fuck
her,
you get better a better fuck. Because I don't have any concerns for your hip being in a funny position.
And
I don't care that I pull some of your hair out.
That is a fundamental difference. I was just talking about this with my friend tonight, a guy friend of mine, who I've slept with, who I've never had sex with, because we don't want to ruin the friendship.
I'm sorry, what does that mean? I don't understand.
We've been in the same bed, we've never had sex.
And he don't want to fuck you.
No, he does, but we don't.
So why are you holding him hostage?
I'm not.
You
are. I mean, he does, but he doesn't. He stopped. Because, like, not,
now, this is the shit. This is the shit that Randy had to deal with, right? Because he thinks if he had enough patience with that, you know what you do with that shit?
What?
If I snuggle you against my will,
yes.
The next day I go, I don't never want to see you again. I never want to see you again.
If you snuggled me against your will.
Yes.
How would it be against your
will? You know what?
It'd be the same thing as me taking your pussy against your will.
It's a lot of...
Same
you know what it is?
You're talking about emotional rape.
Wait, but hold on, Karen. Wait a minute. A lot of women sell men on implied...
And that is wrong.
Future pussy.
That is wrong. That is very wrong.
You do it too.
And it's wrong. No, I
implied
don't.
Implied future
don't.
Pussy.
No, I don't.
I'm not investing in a product that I don't have a clue what it's about.
That's
even
if you
if
don't
somebody,
know if you like them. Like
even
I said, if, it's fundamental.
Even if
we
somebody...
Have
turn
to like
turn the mic off. Any... Even if... I'm sorry, baby. I'm sorry. Even if you have a new drug. A new drug. That you don't know if it works or not, you still get a fucking piece of paper that explains what the drug is. And you get a fucking taste of the product. You can't be sold on an implied product. Turn the mic back on. Sorry, Kathy, I don't want to talk over you. Look how mad she is. Look at her. I'm changing the theme music, too.
Well, if I went
to Sanford and Son. Hold on, Randy. Randy, her new theme music is Sanford and Son. I have to beat her into submission.
Randy, sweetheart, can I just tell you something? Yeah. I appreciate the fact that you're being honest with them. And I think guys do the same BS things that girls do. They go into stuff not really saying what their intentions are. And because you're honest with their intentions. Because
you know what our intentions are.
Well, okay, maybe we do.
Yeah, you do know.
Exactly.
But you know what? If you're going to play, you start playing the game. If guys do what
Randy
does.
Okay, time out, Gareth. I have to hit you with the points you're making to substantiate what I'm saying. The game we're playing.
Yeah.
You know the game is, and it's been in your favor for years. You know we want an implied product.
Right.
You're going to make us do things so long for this implied product.
But if it's worth it, it's good.
It ain't worth
who
it.
Who the fuck knows
it's not
pussy?
I know mine's
the,
worth
the
it.
The more you make me wait, the less it's worth it.
I know mine's worth it.
The more you make me wait, the less it's worth it.
Give me an example of one thing, a specific thing you did to a specific woman and you went, holy fuck, this shit works.
Told her I want to fuck you.
Really?
I mean,
and this is something you never did before.
No, hell no. No, I'd be like, oh, let's go out to dinner, let's go to a movie, and then hope.
Oh, and hope. So wait a minute, though. So, okay, give me a little bit of, okay, so you met the chick, you met this particular girl. Where'd you meet her?
At a bookstore.
At a bookstore.
Oh, that's sweet.
Yeah, the nigga was trying to find... He was looking for books how to get your dick bigger.
Pimping for dummies.
Pimping for dummies. Ball hanging. Is it really something that hangs? It was a bunch of shit like that. So
I
you met her.
Sweet,
did
really.
You take her on a date?
Well, I had cappuccino with
her. Yeah, you did a respectful little something.
The courting. What you talking about? The courting.
But you didn't go the whole, okay, I'm going to take her this, I'm going to bring her that, flowers.
No.
You just said, look, I really want to fuck you. And you know what it is? Again, I think this is new to the show. It may not be. But it's their emotions versus your logic. So if you say to a girl, I would love to eat your pussy right now, her reaction is going to be emotional. You have to be logical and make her go. You have to convince her that she needs to be letting you eat her pussy right now.
Here's the thing.
Something that makes her go, what?
If she likes you, she'll go, oh, you're so crazy, yeah. Which is an implication of the fact that she wants you to,
yes,
without being pissed off about it.
But since you know we're emotional, why don't you fucking use that?
Wait a minute. Whoa, time out, Karis. We've been, Randy, and thank you for calling, Randy. I really appreciate it, too.
Oh, thank you.
Randy has been trying it your way is the way.
The nice guy way.
The nice guy way is the woman's way. That's your way.
Right.
And you, this man is saying, he has been doing that way forever.
But Randy, have you been looking for sex with that or for a real relationship with that?
Guys don't look for a real relationship.
Yes, they do. You are an animal.
No, they don't. We're all animals.
Some guys do want real relationships.
No, but they want sex first, and then if the sex is good and
sex,
I like you,
I know that.
Okay, so that's the prerequisite, and if that's the prerequisite, then address the fact
but
that that's
I wanna,
the
Randy, thanks for calling, man. Hang up on Randy. Thanks for calling, dude. Phil.
Phil from Cali,
sir. Phil.
Yo, what's going on, Patrice?
Hey, man. Sorry I left you hanging so long. What's going on, man?
No worries, dude. Mine kind of goes off that other guy, dude. Look. I am always the friend, and the reason is I learned from you, man. You're my hero. I really don't like women. So once I realized that, hey, I actually like this girl, it's too late. I'm already her friend, and I just can't get to the other side. You know what I mean?
Right. Because yeah, let me tell you something. I'll explain something to you. I'll explain to you what the animals we're dealing with.
Okay.
Women, okay, men want to... get this is just what we want. We want to get pussy and not have to give up time. Women
right.
want to get time and not have to give up pussy. So if you're giving away your time like a little bitch, she gonna take it. Now what how do you treat a woman who just fucks you without any circumstance? You just go, hey bitch, take your pants down, I want to fuck you. You go, this bitch is a hoe. This is great.
Fucking right.
I just get to take advantage of this situation. I don't have to give up no time, have to give up no energy, no flowers. This bitch just comes over and fucks me. Now, after a while, you be with a chick like that, you go, hey, you know, would you fuck my friend? After you tired.
And that's
she go, and she'll go, yep. And you go, enjoy. Now, if you get a girl that you, can you come over and help me move my bookcase? From the basement to the roof and downstairs again. And you fucking go, all right. Can you put together my entertainment stand and can you slide my... There's a mouse in
the
house.
We fall in love with our friends. We fall in love with our friends.
There's a mouse.
We do.
Wait a minute.
Yes,
and then if you get to abuse that man's time with such impunity... You don't think you're going to start passing him around like a little hoe? You think you're going to learn to love him?
I would never loan
you're
a guy
gonna,
out
You're
like
going to loan out his time.
No.
Hey, my friend that's flying in from Vegas, she's coming to stay with me. A friend, by the way, that you're not going to fuck. You're just going to... I'm loaning out your time because you're a time hoe. Go get my friend from the airport, please. Bring her here. Then you go to your house and you can't fuck either one of us. Stupid.
What?
Exactly.
No, first of all, usually there's no airport picking up unless somebody's getting something. Like, that's like what a really, really good friend does for your boyfriend.
Okay, a really, really good friend.
A really good male friend.
So you're trying, let me ask you a question, Phil. Are you trying to get out of the situation? Or you,
in general,
you,
I think he's talking about in general.
But now that I realize that I really like this girl and I want to fucking make something of it, now I want to turn it because when I first met her, I didn't realize I fucking liked her.
Tell her that honesty thing.
Wait a minute, say that one more time.
I said,
he didn't realize
when
it.
I first met her, I didn't realize I fucking dug her. Now that I do, it's already too late. I'm already in that evil friends category, you know what I mean?
Okay, ready though? Ready? Here it is. You can't, you cannot play that game, dude. Here's the game. And again, what that means is, the game is, you can't be afraid of the loss that you're going to take.
Yep.
You can't be afraid. You have to know, okay? My girl wanted me to, she wants to move in my house. Now, she's been around for 5 years. She got a key to my house. She got the thing. I'm not ready for this bitch to be in there all the time. On her period, I don't want her in my house. She has her own house. You go stay in your house on your fucking period.
Oh, my God.
Out you fucking go. Now, that could damage the relationship.
Really?
But it's either She's happy. She's in my fucking house bleeding to death every month. Or I'm happy with a possibility of her being happy.
Are you human?
My fucking happiness is paramount. Because let me tell you why. A man's happiness is very, very simple. It's based on... it's not based on intellectual shit. It's not based on some metaphysical shit. It's based on gut happiness. We can waste time and be happy. We can daydream and be happy. Now, when we're happy and we have an abundance of it, it trickles down to a more complicated, needy creature who needs shit that she don't even know she fucking needs. So I have to be in compliance, and I have to be in tune with your soul to know what is going to make you happy. Now, how the fuck am I going to be in tune to your soul if I'm unhappy?
By talking.
Talking makes me unhappy.
Well, then,
I don't want to fucking talk
to you. Write letters. Some sort of communication.
Yeah,
Jesus
shit,
Christ.
They don't know. Phil, they don't. Let me tell you something, Phil.
We need to.
They don't know what their own happiness is.
Yes, we do.
That's why you got to take control. You have to go, look, I'll figure out how we're going to be happy. I'm not going to let you figure out how we're going to be happy. I am. Because I know what happiness is. Women don't really know.
Why can't you do it together?
Because we can't. Because we... Okay.
Why not?
My girl... Another thing. My girl goes, she wonders why she loves me. She goes, you don't love me like I love you. I go, sweetie, why do you love me? She goes, I'm charming. She goes, I'm smart. She goes, I'm handsome. She goes, all these things, right? And I go, sweetie, why the fuck should I love you because I'm charming? Why the fuck is my charm indicative of how you're supposed to feel about... I'm not supposed... It's not mutual because I lay on some heavy shit to make you want to fuck me. Then I fuck you. You gave me nothing in return except for fuck waiting. Fuck waiting is what I was doing. You didn't give me nothing. You didn't. You kept auditioning me to say, I will fuck him. Once I fuck you, I gave you what I needed to do to get some pussy. You didn't love... If you love me because I'm charming, why can't I love you because you're charming? You haven't been given charm during that whole process. So I have to teach you how to be lovable.
What?
You hear that, Phil?
I'm hearing it, buddy.
You have to teach them how to be lovable. Because they're not lovable. They're leavable.
That, Phil, if you really like this girl...
So as soon as I hang up with you, should I just call her up and be like, hey, I like you. This is what I want.
Yes, I like you.
Yes, you should. And even I agree.
Okay.
Okay.
Who cares what you agree with?
Well, because you're always battling me, saying that like I'm fucking crazy or something. No, I agree. You should let her know. You have to let her know how you feel, because otherwise the game will continue, and you'll be miserable thinking you're just her friend, and she's going to just treat you like that. If she doesn't know how you feel, that's mostly the problem. We don't know how you guys really technically feel.
The second part of that is if she is not with it, don't be a friend.
Exactly.
Don't let her hold you hostage.
Have to step off.
Exactly.
Don't let her hold you hostage.
Phil, you got three people now. First of all, you got a woman who was saying something completely different 5 minutes ago, by the way.
Oh, no.
Don't think I don't catch that
shit. I'm saying don't play games.
I'm fucking super.
Why are you looking at a bully with the cute teeth?
I don't know. He's a good friend of mine. Phil, let me tell you something, man. Let me tell you something.
All right.
And now this particular woman here, this girl in here is fantastic for the show. Because she is so powerfully pro-woman, right? And still says the same exact goofy shit that a goofy hoe would say. Women are women, dude. No matter what level they're on, you got fucking the president, you got fucking a resident. You know? Anybody. They're the same emotional horse shit. They don't know unless you tell them. So, Phil, listen to me. And go in there with a game plan and you be righteous, nigga. This is another thing. You gotta be righteous. Don't play this game thinking that, okay, if I do this, she's gonna... You have to be so willing, as Dante would say, take your ball and go home. If you can't play, you take your fucking ball, nigga, and leave. And you go home, you sit in the fetal position, you eat cupcakes, you do bitch shit, you cry,
jerk
but
off.
You... Trust me, dude. Your logic will always be superior to her emotions. Do you understand? Let her go, what? She's going to do this. Oh, my God, Phil, I can't believe that you would say this to me.
No,
and you go, sweetie, I feel how I feel. And you walk away.
Right.
What's she going
to
do besides go, Phil,
all
right, tell me what you want me to do. First of all, don't you get soft and go,
don't
well,
do
I
it in
just,
a wuss way.
You
don't
just
be
go,
a wuss about
you
it.
Go, I want some ass.
No, you do not say that, Phil. He's insane. Listen to someone. Do not
want,
say that shit, Phil.
Phil,
just be like, look, I really, look, I like you, okay? Here's the situation. I have these feelings for you. Let me know if you feel it back. If not, you know, I'm out.
Hey, Phil, have you, okay, ready?
That is good
You
enough.
Know, instead of cutting her off, I think I'm going to try to fight
Have you been
this.
Doing that the whole fucking show?
All it needs is a finger, bitch. So, okay. I'm going to ask the people, because your advice is advice we heard on every single shitty show that women power is prevalent.
Right.
Now, Phil, her particular advice just now, have you tried that before? Have
yeah,
you tried?
Yeah. I got turned down and then I fucking
did. She wasn't the right girl for you.
Shut the fuck, Tariff. He's saying that he does it anyway. He does it anyway, Karis.
Does what anyway?
He does the girl shit.
No, he tells them that I like them.
This
and you're
is,
not with me.
Karis, you think that I'm leading some Three Stooges man-hating woman club thing? Guys are calling going, dude, I tried it and it works. I'm telling you, because I've tried the... I'm a fat motherfucker, man. Fat guys got to smile their way into pussy. I don't want to.
You know what? We
I
respect,
don't
want to
smile
we respect
my
when you
way
say, when
into
you put,
pussy.
We respect when you... It seems like you're putting your feelings on the line. And like if Phil were to say, look, listen, I like you. This is what I want our relationship to go.
Ugh.
And if you're not with
and
it...
And you know what he's doing?
It is a relationship.
You know what
friends,
he's doing?
That's a relationship.
Okay, you hear what she's saying?
And I'm still jerking off every night.
Thank you, Phil. Phil, you know what? When you take her advice, here's what's going to happen. And
I said the same thing you said.
Here's what's going to happen when you take Carol's, like,
you wussed it up.
The thing. You give her power still. You still go, you still, it's her terms. You go, look, I would like some pussy.
It has to be part of her terms, because if she doesn't like him, what's she going to do?
But then you take your ball and go home.
Bye-bye. I play at another
fucking... And that's what he's saying. But he's empowering himself.
She wants you to say it nice.
That's what I'm saying.
She wants you to
say
it nice.
Don't be a wuss about it. Don't be a wuss.
How the fuck can he not be a wuss?
There is a very... you can do it. Phil, it's possible.
Contradictory Cindy over here. Look at her face. Look at her all despondent. Look at her.
I just shut my mic off.
Look at her. Oh, she's getting sweaty. I like her. There's nothing better than seeing an angry girl with giant titties. Look at her all embarrassing, mad. Look at her. Don't let her do that to you, Karis. Girls will be calling in soon, try to fucking help this asshole. I'm only turning off because you're just talking too much and you're giving bad woman advice. Trust me, Phil. You've been listening. If you've been listening, you know, and it works. Let me tell you when you get home, Phil, do not make it. And here's the thing. You don't just come out and go, hey, bitch, you got to fuck me. You have to say, look, you
I
have
dig
to
you.
Logic.
I dig you.
This
is how I want it to
logic.
Go down.
Yes.
And I don't want it to be platonic. I don't, this is, not, if it's platonic, I'm out.
This shit is, I need some pussy. I have to have some pussy. I ex-girlfriend long time ago, 10 years ago, 15 years ago. We weren't fucking. She said, I don't want to fuck until I get married.
All right.
So I go, look, I understand that. And she liked me a lot. I guess she thought we were going to get married or something. I said, look, I fuck right now and I'm not ready to marry you. So I'm not saying that you should be fucking, but I'm saying I'm not going to be fucking. So you either
put it out there or live with me now,
or you're going to be upset. Which she was. She cried and I rubbed her back. I gave the it's okay circle back rub that girls give us when we can't get pussy. And I gave her that rub. And then I told her, I feel how I feel, and this is what's going to happen.
And that is very fair of you.
All right. There you go, Phil. Thank you for calling, dude. Daddy, what? Your friends leaving? You want to say goodbye to him?
No, it's all good.
Oh, you sure?
It's all
you looked at him like that with this longing look of you're leaving.
No.
Yeah, man. Danny's stepbrother. Hey, Danny, stepbrother. Is he leaving? You guys going? No. Oh, he's on lean.
See?
Your stepbrother loves you. All right, let me see. Is this cousin Joe? Who been on long? We're going to go on order of length of time on the fucking thing. Girl wants to leave. Eric in Baltimore. Go to him. Eric, what's up, man?
What's up, Patrice? You're a genius. I just want to say that right out front because you are an absolute genius. I've been following what you've been doing for a while.
Oh, hold on. Do me a favor, Eric. Before you finish, just tell Kara I'm a genius, too.
Kara, Patrice is an absolute genius. I've been using this stuff for a while. But here's the thing. My girl left me, like, 2 weeks ago.
Aww.
And she left me because... I don't feel bad because I really ain't that upset about it.
We don't feel bad, nigga. That was her with that shit. Did you hear any manly awes, motherfucker? We're like, all right, get on with the story, nigga. So you jerking off and you what?
What's the problem? Get to the point. Get to the goddamn
point. Go ahead, man.
All right, so she left me. She told me she was too crazy to be with me. So she left me, and she said she wants to be by herself, see her shit together, and then come back to me in like 3-4 months when she gets, you know, self, you know, all straightened up and together. And I'm just trying to make logic of it because I'm like, you, Patrice, if she comes at me and says all that stupid stuff, I come back with a straight logic and won't let anything die. And I think I drove her crazy. What really pisses me off is I almost had her trained up the way you taught her because it does work. Because I like skirts and all those, you know, real sexy things. When I met her, she's been wearing them that. Now she does, and, you know, she's just saying stuff like...
So what do you... Wait a minute, though. So when... Okay, you know, there's always a pretense to when a woman talks. What do you think it really, really was?
I honestly don't know. It's... I think I drove her a little crazy, but it was just like the point where she was like, one night, she'd be like, I want to break up with you. The next night, never even happened. The next night, I want to break up with you. And I'll just be
what
like...
What did you say when she said she wanted to break up?
I said, all right, if that's where you want to be.
Good man. She'll be back, dude.
Let me ask
you. You're doing a good thing, though. This guy is fucking a real soldier. Because one thing you did is that they need an emotion to feed off. Women can't stay logical long.
Exactly.
They can't stay logical long. So when you told her that, okay, that's what you got to always do when a chick busts out emotion on you. You got to be cold. I know it's hard because she might have beautiful eyes and she's like crying.
Might
but you go, look, you got to always be thinking to yourself, this, my happiness is paramount. Now, do you want to still be with this girl?
I don't even know right now because she's being crazy. But the really thing that's tripping me out is like, we hang out, we've been dating for like 13 months and we, you know, all are friends. You know, connected together. She goes to my bar that I usually hit up.
Right.
And I'll roll up there, and she'll be like, I love you still, and all this shit, because she wants to get back with me in like 3 months.
Right.
And it's just really tripping me out. I'm trying to, it doesn't make any sense to me.
You know what she's trying to do? It's like this, and Dante has a story that's related to this, but I'm going to give you an example of the position that she's in. Women, again, like I said, in the beginning of the show, women are looking for a general that they feel comfortable fighting for. They looking for a guy that they can believe in. That's what a woman really wants her job to be. They want their job. Women really want to have no job. They want to support a man that they believe in. That's what they want their job to really be. So she's found you, and she fucking... It's like this analogy I use. And I changed my shark analogy, by the way. No tuna.
What happened to the bear?
It's a shark analogy. Oh, right. The bear's still there, but the shark thing. It's a lot of women because they feel like second-class citizens. They feel a little weaker. They feel a little... they don't like loving you and feeling goofy. Like, I've done a magical thing and convinced my girl that I don't have to love her as much as she loves me. It doesn't make sense. You can't love at the same time.
And you can't love the same way.
It's impossible for me to love you exactly how you love me. But women want that to be the case. So what happens is, say you're shark.
Until it happens.
You're great until it happens. If you're a great white shark, a lot of women go, I don't like being the bitch shark. So they swim, and they instead of, like, hanging out with sharks, they go, and Kareth is like this.
Barracuda.
Are you in a relationship right now, Kareth?
No.
Exactly.
I'm dating.
Exactly, dating, whatever the fuck that means. And so whatever title you have, you don't have a boyfriend. So
what do you think about that, Drew, with your cute teeth?
Ain't that a bitch?
He does have nice teeth.
So you're a shark, right? You're a fucking shark swimming around, and you're a man, and here's the female shark. What happens is you have to convince a woman that she should be a female version of that animal, as opposed to the 50-50 animal that she wants to be. So the fact that you're swimming around like, I'm eating motherfuckers. All right, bitch, come on. You eat what I hunt. You eat what I hunt and get. We both eat. You swim behind me in my motherfucking backstream or whatever the fuck that is. Whatever male sharks do, okay? Eventually, female sharks go, I don't fuck this shit. I'm a shark, too. But they're not a shark to anybody else except for
penguins,
seals, fucking walruses that are afraid of them. So when you come up swimming with your teeth like, right, what happens is they go, the penguin goes, oh, here comes a shark. And what you do, instead of eating your food, you grab it and you go, you know I can kill you, right? You know I have power over you, right?
I'm going to date you instead.
But I'm going to let you live. And I'm going to put you on my back and I'm going to let you be this penguin who gets to. That's why a lot of pretty women hunt for, like, funny-looking dudes and fat dudes. That's why a lot of bitches catch up to me, and they just lose. Because they look for fat motherfuckers that they can...
You know, I'm not a small dude. I'm just, you know, I'm a big boy myself.
You're a fat dude? You fat or you big?
I'm big. You know, I'm 6'6", 300. You know,
you're a big motherfucker. So you're intimidating, and here's what they do. They look at you, right, and some little cutie pie thinks that she can control you with her cuteness because she's doing you a fucking favor. That's what a female shark does to her prey. And then she gets tired of swimming around with this fucking pussy-ass penguin. So she goes back to the male shark with this newfound confidence that the penguin's been giving her, and the male shark still goes, all right, where you been, bitch? Let's go back to what we're doing. Now, the only way that relationship can stay survive is if the woman shark submits to being a woman shark and says, okay, male shark, how do I be a shark? Because if you've been living your life, you've been living your life, your whole life being a penguin chaser, you don't even have a fucking clue what it is to be a shark unless I teach you how to be one. Now, here's what this girl did. She left you because she was tired of being a bitch shark. She wants to leave. Right now, she's fucking a penguin.
Don't you worry about it.
She's with some seals.
She is not.
She's with a couple of fucking walruses, and she's like, she's partying, and all the penguins and walruses are going, go shark. But when she comes back to you, you go, all right, you finished, bitch? Now back to shark business.
Didn't he say she was trying to conform or training her?
But what happened?
She's just straight out crazy. Like, she'll go out drinking and be like, oh. She's always been just out. She likes to go drinking, but she doesn't like the fact that I'm like, you know, if you're going to drink, don't be driving.
That's cool.
I'm one of those guys who, you know.
He's giving her fucking guidance.
Can I say something that you're probably not going to believe? If she says she's crazy, believe her. Believe her. You know what I mean? It's just like when a guy says he's a dick.
Crazy.
If he's a dick, you know, girls out there, believe him. Because he's telling you what he is.
I told my girlfriend when we first started dating, I was a royal asshole right off the bat. I told her, I am an asshole because I am a royal asshole to people. And she's like, all right, well, I can deal with that. And she just like, she'll say stuff where like, well, I don't like movies made past like 1980. I'm like, well, you like this movie? You just told me like 2 weeks ago.
Well, no, you shouldn't. But here's the thing. Here's the thing. This is the type of thing we get into these goofy conversations with them. If a bitch tells me she don't like any movies past 1980, depending on the context, if we having a conversation, she's like, I don't like movies past 1980. If she's going, I don't like movies past 1980, and you go, well,
exactly.
Bitch, every movie I like came out in 2009, and ain't even 2009 yet, bitch. Shut up. Who gives a fuck what you like?
Cause that's what I tell her. But she's just like, well, I won't go like that. I'll say, yo, you said that this movie you liked 2 weeks ago.
She's going to change her reference.
And look, man.
Like, no, I didn't say that. I'm like, what? You said that.
Let me tell you something, dude. Let me tell you something, Eric. She is fucking. Is this Eric? Is he Eric?
Yeah.
She's fucking trying to position herself into a better mental place than she is.
Right.
She's a chick who is usually in the driver's seat, and she submitted to you driving. Like, she submitted to you
and
going,
made her uncomfortable.
Shut up, bitch. I got it. And she felt comfortable. Like, my girl, even if I'm lost, I don't get directions from my girl. Shut up, bitch. Because if you knew, we wouldn't be lost now. Shut your fucking face. I'll drive into a ravine before I let you tell me where to go. It's principle, nigga. principle.
I want to say something. Eric, you're doing a good job by keeping her off balance, but the fact that you keep letting her come back is contrary to the philosophy in the first place. If she can keep coming back...
That's the problem, and I love her, but it's just like...
You gotta make a decision and shut it down, because if it loses strength every time you let her come back, because then she starts to feel as though she can come back whenever she wants to come back. She can go fuck penguins and then come back.
And here's what you gotta do, along with what you're saying, you also gotta understand this. Think of yourself as a corporation, right?
All
every
right.
corporation you have, like, okay, Danny works here, you know, Kara's here, Reggie's here, fucking Drew's here, this guy's here, this guy's here, and this is my corporation, right? Even though I have the people in place I want, you still have to have a human resources department. You understand? There still has to be applications being taken. There still have to... You have to... Let me tell you something. You not only have to be sexy to get your girl, you got to be sexy to keep your girl.
Absolutely.
And you have to make other... Only way your girl's going to know that you're sexy is to try and get other girls. You have to keep her having the same exact feeling she had for you when she wanted you. You gotta keep your girl wanting you. You can never, ever think that she has you. If she thinks she has you, it's fucked up by being a great guy. Hey, let me ask you, Eric, was you a great guy before in your life?
I've always been a nice guy, but I'm always a bit of an asshole. I'm not, you know,
you sound like you have the balance. Most people are assholes. You know what I mean? There's a combination in everybody. But here's the deal. Seriously, if she needed a break, if she's crazy, let her go. You know, and I'm not saying that because you deserve to be happy, and she does too. But if she's already coming at you saying, I don't have my shit together.
Here's
she's adorable.
Here's exactly. Hey, look. Here's exactly why you know she don't know what the fuck she wants. She keep coming back.
That's right.
And keep leaving.
And that's not fair to
Eric,
that's
it is fair to you.
It's not fair to him.
It's not. Listen, let me tell you something. I'm going to have to rise above women again. It's never a woman's fault. They just are goofy like that.
Oh, my God.
It's never their fault.
It's our fault.
Eric, it's not her fault. It's your fault.
She can't come back if you don't let her come back.
She has no control over her own shit. She's goofy. If she can get you to be emotional, then she's going to be emotional. Do not take that ride with her. You go, sweetie, I can't take you back right now. Then you know what she'll do? She'll beg and she'll stop. You know what? And then you go, I can't take you back because you're a crazy bitch. I found me another bitch that I've been keeping on the side. Just in case, you know, of emergency. Well, bitch, I broke the glass.
Yeah.
And now I am dating the fire axe. Hey, thanks for calling, Eric, man.
That's what happened a week ago.
Oh, wait.
She came back. What?
Go ahead.
A week ago, she came back to me. Like, we broke up like 2 weeks ago. A week ago, she came back to me and said, yo, I want you back. I made a mistake. And I said, nah, you told me you need a month. If you need like 2-3 months, you're going to have your 2-3 months. And that's... And she's still, like, playing this game and just tripping me out.
Eric, this is Dante. Here's the situation. A woman is like a little kitten, and you are that little piece of yarn dancing in front of her, and she'll keep playing with it as long as it dances around. The minute you drop the yarn in between the kitten's paws, all of a sudden they sniff it, and then they walk away and go find something else. So you got to be consistently inconsistent. And you have to always be elusive to her, and so that she doesn't have control.
On purpose, almost on a conscious level. On a conscious, spiteful level, nigga. It's strategy. Right. It's strategy. Listen, hey Eric, thanks for calling, man. Keep listening, dude. And we're gonna take one more call this segment. I swear we get to all you motherfuckers this show. It's gonna happen. I'm learning. Even though I feel like I've been talking to even longer than last time. Hey, we're going to go to the lovely Nathan in New Hampshire. New Hampshire. Nathan.
Yes.
Oh, motherfucker. I'm sorry for leaving your hole so long. Shit, can I say motherfucker in New Hampshire? Is that legal?
Hell yeah.
Is that like nigger? Are they doing pussy shit like outlawing nigger in New Hampshire? Those goddamn faggots in New York. I'm fucking with you. What's up, man?
Hey, my girlfriend and I have a long-distance relationship going right now, about an hour and 10 minutes apart. And she gets all uptight when I won't come down on work nights. I work a real job. She goes to school.
Mm-hmm.
I work 40 hours a week. She does not work. And she gets all emotional when I won't come down. And today,
selfish.
She mentioned, maybe we should have an open relationship.
She already met a nigga.
She fucking somebody, man.
That's right. Nathan, I want to always give medicine straight. It doesn't, I know it tastes better
Buckley's.
With grape juice.
Buckley's.
But let me tell you something. She's already fucking somebody. Once a woman starts making those suggestions, women always, they never
not
leave themselves hanging. There's no, women do not do things righteously. They always have a pretense. When a bitch says something, when a guy says, hey, look, I want to have an open relationship, he really means I'm getting sick of you, and I think we ought to just go fuck other people. He doesn't necessarily have
maybe
another person lined up. When a woman says that, she has already found, she's like the stepfather. You ever see that movie? The stepfather? The nigga gets tired of his family, and then he goes over across the river and creates another family.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Then
yeah,
he fucking
yeah.
kills his old family.
What?
And then he goes to the stepfather. He's
not going
to
kill you, Nathan.
He knows that. It's called hypothetical context,
I don't
asshole.
So,
it's not going to kill you. Nathan, okay, I'm going to let you talk.
It's friends putting ideas in her head.
No. Dude,
it's already
they already
done.
Put it. Let me tell you why it's already done. She mentioned it to you. There's no, because you know, here it is, epiphany. Women cannot actively decide what relationship they're going to be in. You women sit around and fucking wait.
Waiting.
No.
So she's, you. Are you telling me you think she's going to go? She goes, Nathan, I think we should go and wait.
Maybe that's the catalyst for him to start coming over more. And which, I agree, is
if
really
it is,
hard for you.
Go fuck
maybe
herself.
Maybe that's why she's doing that. You know what I mean? Because she really wants
Nathan,
you.
She's gaming.
All right, well, you know what, too, Carol? I'm going to apologize. Here's what we're going to do, too, because I really love what Carol is bringing. We learn each other.
Mm.
You're going to listen, and you're going to have to be forced, everybody, to listen to the same shit that you're living when Kareth talks. This is what you're living now. This is the horseshit experience that men have to deal with every fucking day.
This is the reason
all
why
I'm
this show is on the air.
Is Black Phillip is
okay.
options. And I'm saying to you, Nathan, knowing what I know, that women cannot, they don't have the ability to progressively and proactively get themselves a man other than stand there with their titties out.
That is so wrong.
And their pussy
wrong.
Smell on their index finger.
That is so wrong. You're
and waiting. You don't know how to go up to a guy and go, hey, how you doing? You looking really nice.
You're going to get fucking
you this, that, and the third. You go, hey, big boy. You can go up to a guy and go, hey, big boy, you want to suck on these monsters? But Nathan, she sat around in her hour and 10 minutes from college. First of all, how old is she and how old are you?
Yeah.
She is 22, I'm 28.
Baby, too.
Okay.
You need to get, you.
I,
let me tell
I,
you something.
I got a life.
It's tough, dude, because she's young and
she's
some young soldier probably took her. Some young, I know it hurts.
She doesn't have a job.
Some young soldier.
It's older soldier.
Yep, some young soldier, because you bring
some
her
Marine.
Wisdom. She's not ready for wisdom. The only women who are really ready, that's why this is a very
loser.
Older show, are only women who are ready for wisdom are athletes who have to get ready to retire from the league. When they get a bad
no
knee
LeBron.
And they're looking at the fucking coach
no LeBron
and they're
James
going, coach, I still got it. Those are the bitches. Bitches your age are the bitches that this works on. 22-year-old women, they don't
want
to hear it. I don't care. I don't even
they
care.
Want what's available.
They want what's
that
available.
They want what's
available. They want some
they
ass.
Want.
They want a young guy to dick him down and play marbles with him.
I don't know.
Now,
that's
dude,
necessarily the case.
Nathan, my advice is that you let it happen, you get yourself a woman, but still get some side pussy.
No.
Well, that's not an issue, you know.
Go ahead.
You know, don't ask, don't tell. She can get some side dick if she wants.
Okay,
don't
fair
let
enough.
Know
all
about
right,
it.
That's fair.
Bitch!
What?
But, you know, I can only do what I can do.
Turn it off. We have to figure out when to turn it off. Nobody wants to hear you going, that's fair? Asshole,
okay,
wait a minute. Nathan, go ahead.
You know, I definitely appreciate your point of view. That's, you know.
Okay, what are you saying, though, Nathan? What do you feel is going on?
I feel that she wants more than I can give her, and you know what? If I can't make it down there, I can't make it down there. And
yeah, but you sound...
So what's going to happen ultimately?
You sound sad.
Yeah, he's...
You sound like...
Oh, no.
Listen to me, Nathan. You sound like you're like... Dude, I want to give her what she wants.
How can I do it?
I want to do it. Dude, it is what it is, man. You got to say that to yourself.
You got
to
work.
It is what it is. You got to work.
You ain't 22.
You don't fuck as much as you did when you was 18, because you know why? The concept of work is introduced, and it's more important than pussy. I can't believe when I found out. Let me tell you, when my credit score went up to 600, I found out that, okay, pussy is less important than making money. And let me tell you, sometimes if I think pussy's gonna distract me from making money, I jerk my dick so I don't have that distraction no more. Because it's a distraction. It's never as easy as jerking off, dude. Okay? Let me tell you, man, she already has a little motherfucker around that she's fucking with. And she knows, because it sounds like in your voice, man, you're not that aggressive with this fucking bitch. You gotta tell her, look, baby, go do your thing and hang up on her. Then she's gonna be stuck with her own goofiness. You're giving her shit that she's seen before. She listen, dude, you're a penguin. Here's what she does. She preys on guys like you, square dudes who work, go out every day, try his best, you're a good guy. While she's out there, you probably buy her books and stuff. You buy her stuff for school, don't you? Don't you?
Not too much for school, but for her.
Yeah, buy her stuff to help her out. Fuck her, dude.
Cut it off, because the 22-year-old guy plowing her.
Don't cut off.
I'm saying the 22 dude that's plowing ain't giving her nothing. Stop addressing her emotional state and her fickleness. You got to take a stand and be righteous about the stand that you take.
Y'all don't know that she's seeing somebody else.
She is.
Okay. Y'all don't know. Nathan, they don't know. You don't know either.
Nathan, we know. Again.
Assume it.
Yeah, assume it, Nathan. It's best to do that. Trust me, dude.
You know what assume does.
Ugh. What is this, Benny Hill? It makes an ass out of you. Shut up, Karen. Pull a titty out, too. Let me see a titty.
Come on,
let me see a titty. All right. Listen. Nathan, dude, call back again next time, but I'm telling you, try. This is what, because we didn't really get what's clear. Let me be clear. First of all, just go, okay, fair enough. This is what you did. You say to her, cool, fair enough. We'll try what you want to try. And she's not expecting you to say that. But you say it righteously. You go, fair enough. And then you don't talk to her. You fight hard not to play the game you want to play, Nathan. Stop playing, dude. Take yourself and get the fuck out of this. I mean, get that side pussy, too. And I bet you your sex life will be better because you won't like her as much. You can put a head in the toilet or something. Oh. Did you ever put a head in the toilet?
It was swirly.
Nathan.
Did you ever suck your dick on the toilet, Nathan?
No, but she is a soldier.
She's a soldier.
Mm-hmm.
But I bet, just
that's
imagine.
What, that's what's
here's
up.
What you don't want to be. You don't want to be that guy that finds out the 22-year-old guy and his friends gave her a double anal or some shit like that.
And you're
the guy that kisses on her forehead and buying her books and cooking her eggs. Fuck that little slut. All right, see you later, Nathan. And we're gonna go. Thank you. And we're gonna go to break. We're gonna get to Jermaine, Cousin Joe, Bob, Victor, Nate, Steve, Christian. I'm telling you, I swear to you. Dude, I swear every show though.
All right,
niggas, listen. I'm getting to you. I swear. All right. See you in a minute.
Call Patrice O'Neill on the Black Phillips Show, 866-WOW-1-WOW.
You can call. I'll listen to you talk about nothing.
That's 866-WOW-1-WOW.
It's Annie Up time, bitch. I'm a pimp. Because he'd probably be on ONA like, you guys should add a little funk to the show. ONA's like, shut the fuck up, Danny, before you're fired and shit. Put on Def Leppard and Shadow, whatever dumb alternative band is out there.
No, because it's funny. Before the show, I'm like, let me try and find some new music for Patrice's show. And I'm going through the soul folder for XM. And I'm sitting there going, yeah, I could put it on a CD. Definitely take it home.
Did you play Shaka Khan for old Shaka Khan cities over there?
Dance your parents.
Oh, she He called whole sack of cotton. Karen's like, I thought you were nice. I told you. Didn't I warn you?
Yes, you did.
Do we need a theme song again?
She just said that.
I haven't.
I think we'll put a theme song back on.
Okay, here it is.
Put her theme song.
Put a theme song back on.
No, it don't work.
See, because y'all fucking with me.
No, 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 that's not a theme song anymore. That's a theme song. Puff me in the ass, big dummy. Tara's theme song, and you're not going to get back Love Me in a Special Way.
It is so opposite of who I
you,
am.
Until you earn it.
That
you are on punishment with... Hey.
Lada, I'm coming to join you.
Open my pussy. Bang twice on my pants and kick my leg and my pussy.
You are so foul.
You don't get Love Me in a Special Way no more. Sanford and Son. And we'll change that shit to the Jeffersons. We'll change it to Good Times, motherfucker.
That is so not me.
Keep acting up. You get Sanford and Son. All right, we're going to go back to the phones, man. Cousin Joe. In New York City.
Joe? Yo.
Joe, what's up, man?
Cousin Joe, what's up, man?
What up, man? You're on the air, sir.
How you doing? I don't know if you remember, but thanks a lot for recording the show ID for the Cousin Joe show on Consumer Radio.
Oh, yeah, you guys. What's happening, man? What's going on? Anything?
All right, man. Well, like, my first day on Cringe Humor Radio, I've been doing a radio show online for, like, I'd say a year and a half now.
Okay.
My big break was to be on Cringe Humor.
Mm-hmm.
That night, my girlfriend came down knowing what a big night it was.
Mm-hmm.
To give me the ring back, I bought her Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
And breaking up with me, right?
Yeah.
So, of course, I went on the air calling her a cunt, or, you know,
okay.
This and that.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, this past week, she wants to get back together with me.
Okay.
She slept over last night.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just not feeling it.
Okay.
I need to know how to break it off without, you know, her getting extremely upset. I can't fucking
Was you extremely upset when she broke up with you?
No, because at that time, I was actually looking for ways to break up with her.
So basically, I'm going to tell you, dude, basically, for real, y'all are just in an abusive relationship.
Yeah.
And you both like it, though. So there's really nothing to say about that. You're both abusive. You both just have this, I don't even know if I call it low self-esteem then.
Sadism.
Thing. But yeah, it's, no, masochism.
Masochism.
It's masochism. Y'all both are into it. Do you guys have freaky sex?
Well, freaky sex. When she slept over, she was on a rag, and I, you know, she thought it would.
You fucked her on a period. She wanted to fuck on a period.
Yeah.
What's wrong with that?
I'll run a red light, baby.
Oh, yeah.
I will run a red light.
You want to fuck a guy in a period? My girl is not. I'm not going near that fucking disaster area, nigga.
What's wrong with you?
I'm not fucking no murder scene, but go ahead, man.
I keep a red towel.
Here's the thing. She told me it was like 5-6 days after she got it. I figured it was okay.
Mm-hmm.
And I fucked her this morning after she slept over. And, you know, my dick slipped out like it happened, you know. And it's just drenched in blood.
Okay.
And I want to fucking puke. But
I
want to
puke now, nigga.
But,
so what's your... Wait a minute, Joe. Wait a second. So your whole thing is, should you get back with her?
Carry dick.
Right.
I would say yes. How old are you, man?
I'm 23.
I would say yes again. I would say yes only because this is not harmful to you. See, wisdom is one of those things, like, if you ever had a kid and you try to tell them something and they just got to learn the hard way, we all do. I am a miserable middle-aged man, as they call it. Well, I'm black, I'm young, but...
I'm old,
nigga. I'm really old for a black guy. So I'm a middle-aged man because I'm a black guy at 37. I lived through this. 14 years ago, I wouldn't have any advice for you because I'm running around trying to figure shit out. This is all based on living life. This is why you can't lose. This is a philosophy. This is field research. This is shit that I live. So I know it's not fake. So I'm saying to you, dude, go out there and damage yourself some more so that you can start to have an actual, like, understanding
character.
And have a personal inner reference to the pain.
Or that, save yourself.
Because you can't just hate and have no basis for it. You know, they have racists and sexists. It's like, you know what? If you want to hate a motherfucker that's not like you because you had bad experiences with him, I don't give a fuck. Just don't hate him for dumb shit. You can't hate, you don't even hate bitches yet. You don't hate her. I can't stand them. They make me sick.
Don't turn into
him. Karis bugs me looking at her.
Don't
I want her titties
him.
Out. I gotta look at the bitch. I want her to be naked. I'm gonna try to get paid. I'm gonna try to pay Karis to come do the show, and part of her show description is have her titties out. But you don't, you're not there
Joe,
yet.
Do not turn into him. So
then Joe,
let her go.
I'm letting him go. Hang up on him, Danny. Thanks, Joe. I'll talk to you soon, buddy. And he just has to learn that, like, young people can take this advice if they want to, but if you
that
haven't
really
lived any pain, if you haven't, like, said, what the fuck, man, if you're not tired, this is a show for motherfuckers who are tired of not being happy and not understanding the thing that's calling in their gut, like their gut, they don't understand something sitting there, and you're like, I hate this bitch. I don't know what. I don't know why. What the fuck? But like, you don't get it.
Joe might have a chance to avoid that pain.
There's no way.
No
like,
way.
You
have to fall.
Well, no.
Have you avoided it?
Well, no. Because
do you
like
know anybody that's
life.
Avoided it?
It's part of life. But what I'm saying is,
okay,
at least in this situation.
Let me tell you something too, Karis. You don't have a statement that completely disagrees with me, and then when I say something that makes sense, you fucking then agree with me, blow it off like you made it up yourself, and then go to another subject. Do you see what
Why
she just did?
Why are you throwing stuff? Why are you throwing
did
stuff?
Did you see what she just did?
Why are you throwing
she
stuff?
She went,
diversion.
This bitch just used the Jedi mind trick. She goes, one plus one equals two. I said, no, equals three. Yes, it does, but see, four is not an even number. What? Bitch, you think I'm a master at this shit? See, fuck, this is what I'm saying.
Stop
this is
throwing
the shit.
Things.
If I was in love with Karis, this
drive
is the
you
shit
drive you
that,
crazy.
That I would, that these guys out here are fucking dealing with because they love her. So if you love a bitch, you gotta hear her horse shit and let her keep going. My girl just wants to tell stories now and have me not interrupt. Just fucking tell stories. And then I was getting my truck fixed. I'm going to the place, and I'm fucking looking at all my children. My girl does these soaps, right? So I call. She'll do, like, extra work on soap sometime. Or she even had a like, actual part on talking. So I call her, I go, these fucking soaps stink, because that's what was playing in the waiting room.
Right.
She goes, yeah, but you know why they stink? Because these soaps, you know where soaps, the acting technique came from? She so wants to tell me something. It's like from Broadway. It's a Broadway thing.
She wants to
blah, blah,
share.
Blah, 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 blah,
she
blah.
Wants to
and
share.
And I'm like, I don't give a fuck. But to her credit, she knows now. She innately has put me as an option to say, wait a minute. This story
fucking
stinks. She's self-governing now.
That's so sad. That is so sad.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is, because she's trying to share a part of herself and her life with you.
How often would guys edit themselves with women all the time?
Well, yeah, probably because like,
oh,
hey, a guy might say breast instead
look
of like titty.
No, but if they it's still self editing. It's the same thing. If a chick says she how do I look in this? Am I fat in this? He goes, oh, you know, yeah.
But it's about communicating.
You go, yeah, you look fat. And then it's over with.
It's about communicating. And we just want to share with you because that's what we do. We are communicators. We talk.
You're
we
not communicators. You know
not.
What you are? You're
no.
fucking talkers. Communicators actually put something in my head with see,
some
men,
value.
Men are actually trying
that's
to give
you. That's
valuable
to us, though. You're just.
Did you hear what you said? Whoa, whoa.
That's the point.
Repeat yourself.
That is the point.
It's valuable to who?
Us.
There you go. Now, we're going to take another call.
Yeah, you got to wait for Danny.
Oh, we're stupid Danny.
I'm saying, Danny, come back in here.
He's picking out his afro.
who's that fucking guy? Go to Steve, man. Steve, number seven. Steve, what's up? This is Patrice.
Hey, Mr. P, what's going on?
Oh, Mr. fucking P, goddammit. What's up, man?
Hey, listen up. I was going to ask you.
Steve?
Did he hang up?
I think he was trying to get you. It just didn't, didn't work very well.
He held on for an hour and 40 minutes for that, dickhead.
I hope his cell phone battery ran out right in time.
He did. That sounds
like a Jim
Norton. He held on
that long for that.
No fucking way did he hold on that long to do that.
No, it was probably an accident.
To get me? Are you fucking kidding me?
That's the sound of it.
What a fucking soldier.
I wouldn't be surprised, though.
What a... He's an animal. Crap. I want him working for me, nigga. This nigga held on from 9 p.m.?
Yeah. What time is it?
Just his cell phone battery.
It's almost 10 o'clock. It's almost 11. 11. That's a crazy nigga there. I would not want him stalking me. What's the name? What's the other? We want the people that hung on the longest. So I don't even know.
Let's see.
19?
Yeah.
Now, this guy's been on. Jermaine in Pennsylvania.
Jermaine, okay. Jermaine, what's up, man?
Hey, man, what's up?
How are you, sir?
Not bad, not bad.
All
I got a situation for you guys.
All right.
Me and my girlfriend have been going out for about a year and a half.
Fair enough.
I'm 19, she's 20.
Okay, sounds good.
We both still live at home with our families, so I drive to see her a lot.
That's good. Does she have a basement, or you have a basement, or somewhere y'all can fuck? Are y'all doing it in the car?
Mainly, you know, when no one's home or at night, late at night.
Yeah, I miss those days. Yeah. You know, I had to sneak some pussy. But what's good about it, though, the bitch gotta leave.
Yeah. Well,
you don't have to
struggle
with it. Get out, ho. That's a good thing when you live with your parents, but go ahead. My bitch don't go nowhere. I gotta hide in the closet from this, ho. Go ahead.
Well, the only problem is she lives with her stepbrother now, who used to be her boyfriend.
Wait a minute, well, that's not even a big deal yet. She lives with her stepbrother,
who's her ex-boyfriend,
who used to be a boyfriend, which means his mother married her father.
Right.
He didn't say anything yet?
No. Yeah.
Hold on, it could be just a fucking Brady Bunch thing. He's up.
She's dating him, though.
No, she... So what? That has nothing to do with who? All
right, Steve, go ahead.
Do you hear how he's trying... Wait, time out. I'm sorry, Josh. Jermaine, is it Jermaine?
Jermaine.
Yeah,
Jermaine,
yeah.
Do you see how guys... This is what guys have to deal with. If you aren't with a woman that's trained to have you say, shut the fuck up, they'll keep on... Bleh, 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 bleh. Or if you don't have a mic that you can shut off, like right now... They go, blunt, 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 and you're like, wait a minute, hold on. So I end up being fucking annoying to Jermaine and not listening because Carolyn's going, oh my goodness gracious. He didn't say anything yet. Exactly. We're going to let you explain, Jermaine, but do you see how you got to get in to tell a bitch once her emotions take over and she has a movie that's starring her and directed by her and co-starring her and that movie just goes, and action, oh my God, he's sucking his stepbrother's dick. Oh, God. He didn't say shit yet, motherfucker. All right, keep her mic still off, though. Go ahead. She's still on parking for 5 seconds.
They were dating, then their parents got married, and now they live together.
Live together with the parents?
Yeah, they all with the parents.
It's a Brady Bunch situation right now, right?
Yeah,
okay, go ahead. Right. Keep going.
You know, she's very nice, sweet, smart, sexy girl. She's really... She's still really good friends with her stepbrother, though, and I can't really handle this.
I'm going to tell you why you shouldn't worry about it. What part of Pennsylvania you live in?
Eastern, southeastern.
Is it religious, that area?
No.
Is it a religious area? Like, is it like Pittsburgh or some goofy shit like that, or no? I'm not familiar with Pennsylvania.
Allentown, Bethlehem area.
Yeah. Okay, I'll tell you what you hope and you cross your fingers for. You cross your fingers, and this is the only thing. First of all, your confidence in not giving a fuck will help. But what I always do, I always tease, like, I would tease my girl and act like I wanted to actually see her fuck the guy. And
you know what? I was actually thinking about that.
Yeah, and then what happens is she goes, oh my God. I can't. Yeah, well, really, y'all not related. You know, we can do a little Brady Bunch thing. Let's do a little Brady. You may not mean it, but mean it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because it is, she's not related to him, but you hope that the idea of the immoralness of it keeps her from fucking her new brother. That if you can keep, if she thinks that you're a hunk of shit, and now you put the idea of her fucking her brother in her own head, then she won't fuck him.
Or that's planting seeds. That's planting seeds.
Well, that's what you gotta do, bitch.
Yeah, but
but that's
is that gross and it's what? But that's what you do. That's what you do. You plant. You plant.
Is the brother hot?
He's not bad looking.
It doesn't matter.
Yes, it does.
It doesn't fucking. It does, Jermaine. It doesn't matter. Here's what, Jermaine. Are you a white guy?
Yeah, I'm a white guy.
How that happened? Yeah. I just noticed. What's up, nigga? What's happening, baby? Jermaine from Pennsylvania. Hey, Jermaine, listen to me, dude. Trust me. You just tease her a little. It's insecurity, but you joke about it and you're very comfortable. After you joke about it a couple of times, you don't talk about it no more. You can't care.
All right.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, don't
bring it up. Don't flip out. Don't fucking, what the fuck? Right. Just try to make her think that she's a hunk of shit for thinking about fucking her brother. It's like, Jesus, it's your brother. Doesn't the kids come out retarded? It's not her brother, but you put that in there like it is her brother, like it's somebody she has to look at like family now. And then you step back and you don't fuck with her about it. You understand what I'm saying to you?
Yeah.
All right, I'll see you later, dude. Thanks for calling, man. Shit, these fucking phone things. I can't get used to this phone shit. What's good?
Nate's been on for a while.
Has he been on?
Yeah.
Not much of the guys has been on, dude.
Let's go to Nate.
Cleveland, Nate, what's up, buddy?
Yo, what's going on?
How are you, man?
All right, hey, I got a good one for you.
Go ahead.
I'll give you the quick and dirty on it.
Okay.
This chick and I, we were dating, like, way back in the day. We split up. Loved her to death, but there was issues. But then last night, I ran into her again, and I'm
Wait,
like,
what,
holy
what was
shit.
The, what was the issues real quick?
her and I both want to control the relationship.
All right, fair enough. That's an issue that's always around, though. You know, that's something, like I said, that's not her fault. You understand?
No.
That's what they do. So, you know, that shouldn't be an issue in your life ever again. You know, right? You know that?
No. Yeah, no. We went back and forth.
Okay. How old are you, by the way?
25.
25. Okay, you're getting there. So you was just in that abusive kind of masochistic shit that we all into. When we're younger, we just... That fighting, you think this is stuff we have to go through as a relationship. But as you get older, you don't need to go through that shit. But go ahead. Sorry, man. Go ahead.
When it's easy, it's not worth it.
Right.
But nonetheless.
Pain is suffering, right.
Yeah. And then I ran into her last night. Mm-hmm. And now when this girl and I split up, ever since that point, I'm kind of like the way you think. So I'm just like, you know, I'll be with somebody for like a week, and I'm like, you know what, I'm tired of you, get out. And it's just, that's kind of the way that I've been.
Okay.
And it's because of her. And I ran into her last night, and I'm like, holy shit. You know, here's this chick that I was crazy about, and we just kind of, like, hit it off immediately.
Old
like,
feelings
right,
and
cool.
shit. Okay,
yeah,
right. She was it. She tapped into something. You know, that's fair. You find a girl that's taps into something. They do that. You know, they do, you know, that's why sometimes you see a really, you know, couples where one person shouldn't be with the other in terms of the looks. You know what I'm saying? It's because she taps into something. So, okay, that's fair.
Yeah, so, and she was like, you know, I'm sorry, I was stupid, you were right, you know, and just kind of like caved everything and said, you know, I regret it like crazy. I'm like, okay, cool.
Okay.
The rebound guy from me knocked her up. Now she has two kids.
I mean, look, here's what you do. Here's what you do. You might not be able to make her your main, but at least you know one thing. She's fucking.
You splash off. You can splash
and
off every once in a
while.
Here's
the thing, too. You can. Here's what you do, dude. You're 25. You really like this girl. You learn about your future relationships that you're going to have when you get older. You take this as experimental. And here's why you can do that. Here's the experimental relationship factor. You can always, when she decides she's trying to be your girlfriend, you always can hold the kids over her head.
And that's healthy. That's very healthy.
He's not healthy in a healthy relationship with her anyway. So what you do is when she starts
he's
going, why are you doing this? Why are you saying that? When she starts giving you trouble, you fucking hold her kids. You don't think I've done
that's
it?
Like
and stop my.
I know you have.
Let me tell you, I told you. My girl said, why you got your ex-girlfriend's boots in the closet? I said, why the fuck do you. You got a kid that ain't mine, bitch. You complaining about my girlfriend's boots? I don't feed the boots. I don't talk to the boots. I don't help the boots with math. I don't do any of that shit. How dare you open your fucking mouth? That's what you got to do. You know what the kids help you do? They help you to give her options. They help you to understand, baby, you just do not frivolously say anything to me. Because you're coming back to me after you fucked the guy, no condom, squirted in you, gave birth. Now you back with some product of some other guy's balls.
Oh, my God. Did you make that any grosser?
In my face? You understand what I'm saying?
She didn't go looking for him.
So this is what you do. Listen, it sounds like you're not over her. She went out and did the things. Don't ever make it the kid's fault, though, because they didn't do anything. The mom is a hoe. You know what I'm saying? She did her thing.
The whole thing behind it is I was a relationship guy before I met her. I was like, you know, I want just like long-term committed. You know, I was a pussy. That's exactly what I was.
That's not
and when she hurt me, I took that, and I'm just like, you know what? Fuck all the bitches. I'm just going to be whoever I'm going to be. If they don't like it, they can leave. And now she came back, and I'm like, oh, shit, this is what made me this way. What the fuck?
Look, dude, let me tell you something. You love her, and it's a good thing she came back with some furniture.
Yeah,
right?
She
and she came back with a...
She came back with a whole house.
She came back with a funky couch and a chair you don't like.
An ottoman.
And you have... Right now, you have a nicer house... But you let her bring her little chair and ottoman in, right?
Mm-hmm.
And now all you got to do, you sit on it, you talk to it. But that is a good way for you to now learn how to be in a relationship.
Yes.
When she gets crazy, those kids are an option. You don't threaten to leave because of the kids.
No.
You just go, sweetie, you're complaining about what? I am looking at another guy's humping.
That's fucked up.
Do you understand what I'm saying? When you're fucking her and she's acting funny, I don't like it. Then you go, really? Really? At least I'm wearing a condom. Mr. Shoot Up In Your Pussy got to shoot up in it, didn't he?
Oh, my God.
You got to do it, dude. I'm telling you. You got to do it. Don't be a complete dick, but just use it as leverage to introduce options. All right?
All right.
All right, see you later.
Take care.
All right, Mr. Victor from Florida. God damn it, I am sorry, Victor. Are you there?
I'm here, man.
Go ahead, man.
Oh, okay, cool. First of all, I love fucking period pussy. I don't know what your problem
dude,
is.
Dude, maybe I'm a fag. I don't know. It's
me
just,
too.
It's just waste.
Nice and warm.
I used to think it was just blood. It's old eggs coming down.
Man.
It makes me sick.
It's nature's lubrication, man.
It's like fucking caviar.
it's like fucking
a cup of caviar. I don't need it in my life. I don't need it.
It's an acquired taste.
Oh, man. Am I the only pussy-ass motherfucker
yes,
who fucks on their period?
You are.
Danny, you fuck on your period?
I try to avoid it, but if it happens it doesn't matter.
I don't want my girl near me with a bloody pussy, man. I don't. It gives me.
You got a creepy
Steve.
Thing about panty shields too, though.
Nigga, I don't like.
Really?
If I see panty shields and a bitch just to protect from discharge, I almost pass the fuck out. Some old sticky pussy juice. I'm sorry. I can't track because I guess a lot of. I'm out, man.
I will use a panty shield as a napkin.
Oh. Dab off, nigga.
Taking a dab off the mouth, of course.
Oh, when I hear that fucking Velcro sound of a panty shield coming out. Fuck all you motherfuckers with that shit. That's some gross shit to me, dude. I'm sorry.
I think that is hilarious.
I know I'm a piece of shit.
You're the only one I feel is equally as freaky as I am. And
you
talk about a panty shield.
You know, nigga, I will.
Like, man.
I will eat a bitch's asshole after she finished wrestling. But fucking period pussy, I cannot fuck. You period fucker? Fuck.
All the time, man.
All right, dude. All right, go ahead, man. Go ahead, man.
Yeah, well, all right. First of all, I kind of relate to that last caller because I feel that I'm definitely a pussy. I've given my girl way too much power in the relationship. My problem is basically jealousy, man. You ever get jealous?
You know what? I do, but it's something you have to fight. It's like when I wanted to swing. I just needed some side pussy. And for me to want to do that, I had to be willing to deal with her wanting to fuck another guy. I don't want to be a hypocrite for her, because if she's giving to me, I got to give to her. So I did watch some other guy fuck her. And I did watch some other guy, she blew another guy. And what I found is that under the context of swinging didn't bother me. I think what fucks you up is the intimacy of the unknown, learning someone else, and that some guy fucking fell in there, and like it was an open window, and it's just the unknown of it. So I do get jealous, but I get as jealous as I can, because I've been in a business so long that rejection is such a part of my daily lifestyle, and disappointment, that put it this way. How you deal with jealousy, I always say this, is you love a bitch 80%. Like, if there's 100% of a pie, you build up to 80, but you got to save 20% for two things. 10% to be able to fuck her correctly, to have the right resentment, to be able to fuck her like an animal. And the other 10% is to be able to move on and have some energy, because if I give a bitch 100%, then what do I have for me? I have nothing for me. So stay with
me. I'm giving my bitch 150%. That's the fucking
That's what
problem.
You got to do. Yeah. You got to slow down what you give her, and you got to now take stuff and make it for you. You have to go down. You can't. The most you can do is 90%. You need 10% just in case this bitch is phony, or just in case. And the same thing goes for women.
Absolutely.
You have to give. You can't love a motherfucker 100%. That's what you believe it. Look, human beings, man, we're prone to mistakes. Human nature is prone to those fucking mistakes, man, because we're animals, dude. Sometimes we act on that animal thing, and you get this fucked up thing. Like, my girl, I know my girl used to fuck a lot of people, you know, and I don't give a fuck. I fucked a lot of people. I like a bitch. As a matter of fact, if a bitch come to me and tell me she ain't sucked 18 dicks in her life, she might as well not fuck with me.
No, man, you're fucking crazy, bro.
I like teaching a bitch.
That's the best, man.
Here's the difference between me and you,
ego.
Victor. You, me, I am a ninth Dan professional.
Oh.
When you come into my karate class, I can't teach motherfucking white belts. I only can teach black belts. I teach black belts. So when a bitch come to me thinking that she sucked your dick right, I go, very good, very good. Can you do it with my thumb pressed against your larynx? No, you cannot. And then I pull the bitch's eye out like Kill Bill. I like hoes myself. So here's the thing, Victor. With your thoughts, here's what's going to happen. You can only take her, and listen, think about this. You can only take her, but so high. Then she's going to look to explore and find pieces of shit like me. And you don't want her to find pieces of shit like me or Dante or fucking Drew Boogie. You have to learn. You know what you do, dude? I'm going to tell you what you do. Because you won't be as hurt as you think. Go to a swing club. Go to a swing club. You switch with a couple. Sit there. Have another guy's girl in your clutches. And watch your girl fuck another dude.
Wait, but I don't have a problem with the swing thing. That I don't have a problem with.
But you have to learn, though. You have to learn how to deal with the pain and the ego. The ego is what you have to get out of your system. Because you know what it is? You're not. It's a possession. It's almost like a motherfucker that has a lot of watches, and he only wears one. And your boy comes and you go, damn, dude, let me get that other watch.
Motherfucker,
get out of here. It's my watch. Sometimes we treat our bitches like they just another watch that we have in a drawer, and you start to lose that attachment, and you start to get this fucked up ego when they start thinking how you do. You know what I mean? Because that's what they do. They copy you. You understand? Women don't have their own thoughts.
Oh, my God. Are you trying to make my head explode?
Listen to me. Victor, you have to learn. Here's what you do, dude. Okay. You should think in your mind.
That was for you.
Never that jealousy thing. Because this kid sounds like he's one of those fighters and shit that fucking gets steamed up. And here's what you do. Let me tell you something, man. Dante wants to give my girl a fat one. We boys. But my girl got a nice booty, and Dante gives me respect. Every time my girl, Dante hugs my girl and goes, hey, baby, how you doing? Hi, Vaughn. And I can feel it. But he doesn't want to.
You gotta move.
He's fighting what he is, but he respects me as a man.
For real.
But he'd want to fuck my girl. Why should I be upset with that? His wife is, you know, I gotta close, you know, you close your eyes. You put
you gotta,
the, you know, you go, hi, sweetie. How you doing, baby? And you look down because you don't want to go, oh, Jesus Christ, man. Because you respect him, but right. He should want me to want to fuck his wife.
Smoking.
You have to want other guys to fuck your girl. Yeah. You understand what I'm saying? You know, what do you want, a girl? Do you want a girl who guys don't want to fuck?
No, of course not.
No, but I want a girl who doesn't want to fuck other guys.
Oh, no,
you don't have a brain.
That's what it is, dude. You gotta.
You think you got a body?
You don't possess. You can't possess her body unless you possess her mind.
You can't possess anybody. This is not slavery.
That's bullshit.
Possessing a mind. Wait a minute,
Victor.
Possessing a mind is free will. Possessing a body is control. If you can possess a mind, she's freely giving you her mind. That's not your fault.
How many guys?
Thanks for calling, Victor.
With some girl that they hate and is doing everything they're doing everything she wants them to do? They possess their mind.
That's
we
bad,
dudes.
Though. It's not right.
But you're trying to.
But that happens all the time.
I know it does.
Let me ask you a quick question, Karen. Please give me the principles of having a 50-50 relationship.
I don't think it's always 50-50 at the same time.
There you go. Contradiction again.
No, but you both have to give. It just has to. And that's what makes it 50-50. You alternate. Come on.
How do you give a girl a 50-50? How do you have a 50-50 relationship?
You alternate. It's effort. Everybody has to put in some effort
how
for
do
a
you
relationship.
Alternate.
So what happens
even
when one
because
gives?
You know what? Somebody has a good day. Somebody has a bad day.
So you're saying a relationship is like a seesaw.
You give a little bit more.
It's like a seesaw.
Absolutely.
No.
It's
like tug of war.
No, it's not. Your world, if it's a fight, it is a fight.
You know why? It's just like you, and you do very classic things like, why are you yelling? Why are you throwing pins? That's what girls
aggressive.
Do. You try to take, and this is the last bastion of madness, is our anger, is our physical imposingness.
That's the passive aggressive.
Over women is the last thing that they're trying to fucking take. Because they know, if they can figure out a way to take the fact that we can punch them through a wall, they would take that
phone,
and that would be the final frontier is to take testosterone.
We like testosterone.
The bear salmon.
Oh, that's
scenario.
The scenario.
Yeah.
It's just like it's like working in a workplace.
Mm-hmm.
Business
right?
office.
A business office, right? Mm-hmm. And men working with women is just like bear working with salmon dipped in honey. And the salmon comes in and starts talking to the bear about all kind of stupid shit. Hello, bear. Hello, Jim the bear. And he's like, I just want to eat this bitch. But the fact is, I want to eat this fish. fucking fish. And every day, I'm going against my entire nature of, just like we're working together now, and I'm like, pull your titties out. But that's... It's like, because of the dynamic, you can go, you're a fucking asshole, but you don't work for me, so there's no power move, so get out. But at work, a guy wants to do, if you came to work with those titties, right, I can't.
I'm not even wearing a seductive top. I'm wearing a cowl neck.
There you
big
go.
Lavender
it's all
titties.
It's all about you, right? If you come to work with those tits, right?
Yes.
And you're a salmon dipped in honey right now.
Okay.
So I'm sitting there like fuck, and you're telling me shit, and you're not asking me shit, you're telling me shit. You're like, hey, this is what I like, this is what I'm gonna do, this is blah 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 and blah. And then one day, I go, you know. That honey looks good. And you go, oh my god. Oh my god, you're harassing me. Oh, you're doing me right, right, right. Oh my god, I'm gonna write you up and talk to the fucking supervisor. I can't stand it anymore. And it's an unfair thing that you're doing to us.
Keep your bear claws off my fin.
Keep your fucking honey out of my face, bitch. Work in the basement. I don't think women and men should work together.
I agree.
They should have.
Leave
I
my
think
scales
they
alone.
Don't. They should not work together because I don't get to say, "Hey, you got nice titties." That's my dynamic. Why do you get to fucking unleash? Oh, really? You're
fine. Say it at a fucking club and get slapped, but you wouldn't say that in the workplace.
Why?
Why? Because it's unprofessional.
Do you hear how she has?
No, I would.
You hear how women have no reasoning?
That is reasoning. Why are you calling that no reasoning? I just said unprofessional. That is a reason.
No, that's not a reason. That's a social.
What does that mean?
That's a social answer.
What does that mean?
Unprofessional means uncalled for, uncouth. It's not.
How do I know? How do I know that? Hey, listen. Are you a virgin? Wait, are you a virgin?
No, I'm not.
Do you give up pussy from time to time?
Yes, I do.
How the fuck am I supposed to know if at work maybe I got a chance for you to give me some pussy? How do I fucking know?
Wait till after hours if you want to touch me.
Are you out of your fucking mind? Because then that's even worse.
What?
Here's what guys got to do at work. Hey, I just was looking at you earlier.
I've never worked with men.
I thought that.
I don't know.
I think that you should come out for a lovely lunch. We're going to go to, you know, Sporty Deluxe and have a hamburger and blah, blah, blah,
it's
blah,
the mating
blah.
Ritual, which you have to follow.
Do you hear? Carol, I'm so fucking happy you're here. This is the stupid shit that men hear all the time. Please stay you. Don't change, because this is how we get frustrated. They say shit that means nothing just to them. It's the dating
all
ritual.
All the women are listening understand.
It's the dating ritual. You gotta ask me out on a date. Pussy is important, but it ain't special. I tell you that much.
Yes,
it ain't special. It's important, though.
Wait, Patrice.
Yeah.
The last guy that called doesn't have the girl's brain, and we say this every show. And every time I look at Danny, because we was talking to him about it, when he was talking about his girl, about guys that can't, that think that they can fuck their way to making their girl stay with them.
No, we have to like you. We have to feel connected.
Do you remember what I'm talking about?
Yes. Hold on. Okay. I'm sorry, fuck it. All right. Drew, I know what you're talking about. Santino in Massachusetts.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Go ahead, Santino.
Hello?
Yes, sir, Santino. Please, speak up, sir. I hope you're saying...
Ugh.
I see you, Santino. Go ahead.
Patrice, you are 100% right. And the girl, I'm sorry, I forget your name.
Kareth.
Kara, you're proving Patrice 100% right, all right? He's asking you specific questions. You're being very vague in what you say.
But I'm
even
not!
No, listen for a second. Even if it's stupid, give him a solid answer. You know what I mean? Hey, why do I do this? You go, oh, well, these that. You say, even if it's stupid, say, it's because I'm a woman, I should do this.
Because.
You say, it's because I'm a man, that's why. You know?
That's Jackie Mason.
Yeah, we don't. Men never say, because I'm a. I say, do this. Because we go, this is the reasoning behind what I'm saying.
You know what?
You have no reasoning to why I can't say, can I look at your titty?
It makes us feel weird when you say, hey, nice tits at the office place. That's why it's inappropriate.
When is there an appropriate time to say, hey, nice tits?
When you're at a bar and you want to get slapped.
And you think that you could slap somebody
Santino, thank you so much for calling.
Sometimes you say thank you and you walk on. But
thank
that's not
you,
a way
sir,
to get a number.
Calling.
That's
listen
certainly
to
not a way
just
to get
listen,
my
listen
phone number. You're
listen
such
to
a dick.
God damn it, fucking Kev. Unbelievable. God damn
it. The reason why the answers are vague is because the minute you make your point and you make a sound, concrete point, then we can attack your point with logic. As long as you keep it vague and you never take a position, then once we start backing you into the corner, then
sides.
You float. You start floating
I'm
around
not,
and, you change
sides,
your position.
But I'm trying to get you to understand where women are coming from too. You want a question?
We
but
know.
That answer is reasonable.
You're coming
the point
from
is
vagueness.
The point
you
is we do know. We do. We
you
just
don't
accept it. We know exactly where you're coming from.
Okay.
It's bullshit, and we know it's bullshit.
And
we
it's not up, bullshit to us.
Of course it's not, because it's your point of view. It's still bullshit.
What's up, girls? Please call in. I need pussy power here with me.
Exactly. Right, ladies?
Right.
Do you see how goofy they are? And this, it only works.
Women understand what I'm saying.
But wait a minute, Dante.
They don't know what the fuck
exactly.
They're talking about either.
Guys, like, listen to me. They would understand where women are coming
blind
from.
I don't even have the blind.
We have always listened.
I
guys,
am not blind.
Guys
can...
always have listened to women. That's how we talk you into fucking us. We know where you're coming from.
So then what are you bitching about?
It shouldn't be that way. It shouldn't be that way.
That's hell, you.
Because you want to fuck just as much as we want to fuck.
Every guy who is fucking lying is the, when they write in, she's an asshole.
What? Somebody said I'm an asshole? Two people said I'm an asshole? Are you fucking kidding me?
Five, but we just won't take them. We just wouldn't take the call. Five people said this chick is an ass. You come in.
Good. I'm glad I got you.
Because she has this confidence that's based on the fact that men let her fucking ramble
that's
on.
Right.
So she just comes out with this power, like, you know, I'm going to say this. And then I go, you're wrong. Yeah, maybe, but I'm going to say the next thing. That's all bitches. This is what I'm going to say, Kev. It's not personal to you. It's all fucking women. They're annoying. Annoying. All right. And I didn't turn the mic off, by the way.
That's good.
Good girl. Now, when you pull out a titty, we'll have a situation. Who can I call? Homebusters, bitch, because... Big Daddy, man. Go to Big Daddy. Big Daddy, you there? Big Daddy? Virginia?
Yeah, man.
You there?
Yeah.
What's up, man?
Yeah, first thing, if women don't want to be talked to that way, then why do they wear scandalous clothes like that in an office place where people are working?
That's a heavy word, too. That's a word that causes pain. When you say scandalous, you know what that means? It means, like, it's unfair. It's unfair for you to pretend like you're not trying to be sexy, right? You're not inviting anything.
You have to control your loins.
Wait a minute. But I can't say, but you're flashing. You know what?
Am I flashing?
Okay, wait a minute. What are titties? Wait a minute. What are titties? Would you say titties are a sexual tool to allure men?
No, they're to feed children.
Do you have kids?
No.
Why do I know about your titties? Why do I know you got big, giant, soggy tits? Why do I know that?
What are you doing with those titties without kids?
You can see that I'm not wearing fucking burka. That's why you know about them.
Really? So that you can stand up and say, I can do anything as a woman, but a guy goes, hey, baby, you know what? That anything you're doing is making my dick hard. Can I pull my dick out and jerk my dick? Can I dress my dick up? Can I come to work in a fucking just a jock strap on so you can see how big my balls are, but I don't show them?
If I was flat-chested and wearing this top, you wouldn't be saying anything. This isn't
even a revealing
top. Of course not.
Nobody would see your little boy chest.
These people think that I'm wearing like some low-cut shit and a halter top.
I'm going to tell you what she's wearing.
A lovely New York and company.
Let me tell you something. You could be wearing armor if your titties were out. I'm jerking off to the armor. If you had titty armor, you ever see cartoons
Xena.
And the bitch put Xena and the bitch have a pair of titties to go to? You're like, damn, that bitch got some iron titties. You want that shit. I'm sorry, dude. Big Daddy, go ahead. Go ahead, man. Go ahead, because you had a question.
And one more thing there, Patrice.
Yes, sir.
You know, I can walk through mud, but I can't fuck through blood, so I agree with you on that one.
Thank you.
But,
delicious. Thanks for calling, dude. Big Daddy, keep listening, man. Thank you, sir.
Bye, Big Daddy.
Fucking, he don't want blood, God damn it.
What does a guy that eats pussy on a period?
Ooh,
no, I don't
want
to even talk to this dirty bastard.
That's wrong. That's
probably
wrong.
Oh, hey, Monique. Gotta go to a girl. There's a girl. Matter of fact, we're gonna give it over to Monique and Karen for 5 seconds. Go ahead, lady.
Hi, Monique.
While we all go take shits and play PlayStation.
Do you hear these assholes?
Pull my ball hairs out with a tweezer.
Uh-oh, whoa. Hold up. Wait, Monique. Wait a second. Wait. Stop the presses. Say that one more time, beautiful.
I'm on the men's side.
Holy shit. I'm just going to sit on back and
let
two colleagues talk. Go ahead, sweetie. Go ahead, Karen. You had a radio show.
And you're on the men's side because?
because women are emotional and men are analytical. Men will tell you what they want, but they're afraid to. And they know they're not going to get the truth from women because women want to never be pinned down because they want to change their mind all the time.
Didn't I just say that?
Wow. Wait, no.
Thank
don't
you,
wait.
I'm not saying, okay. I disagree with that. Like, and I'm not disagreeing with them on that. What I'm saying is they're not validating our feelings. Like, if they know that we are this way, why are they bitching about it?
Okay, here it is.
Because we are emotional.
Ready?
And there's nothing wrong
here
with
it.
They're trying to make it seem like it's
wrong.
Whoa,
here it is.
Men are bitching because they can never win with us.
Exactly.
Ever.
Thank you.
Oh, that's tricky,
no,
ho.
No.
Hold on, Monique. Hold on.
Thank you.
Monique, hold on a second. Here's the thing. Here's what it is. It's women and men have emotions, but men have tapped into this thing called analytical thinking and philosophical thinking.
Logic.
And that's why we're up on you because like when I ask you a question, just like Ms. Santino said, because men will say, like my girl said, can't you stop saying bitch? Can't you stop acting like you're a pimp? And all I have to do is go,
why?
Do you have another option for me, bitch? You have another way for me to think? Give me a plan B. I got plan Z for you, motherfucker.
But why does that make you right and us wrong if we...
Because you have no guy. You have... We're both... You know, we're like... We're two weeble wobbles, not falling down, but we're just going back and forth.
Why does it have to be right
nothing.
Or wrong? You're making it a wrong.
Do you hear
no.
this? Karis, this double-talking...
Yes, go ahead, Monique.
Your question, why can't you just answer him? Why do you always have to have either two answers or... None.
Monique is my new girlfriend. Me and my girlfriend are going to fuck Monique now.
No. I get called harsh and too strong-willed because if somebody asks me a question, I'll answer it.
I think
and
that's
it's awesome. Not usually what they want to hear.
But we're also not trained to do that. We're not trained to do that. I tell the truth, too.
So is that right or
but
wrong?
But I also try not to hurt people's feelings, which I think is what we do
is
as well. We're trained
right
to do that. Because
wrong.
We are
is it right or wrong, Karen?
Not hurting someone's feeling is fine. But again, if you're not telling them the truth, it's a lot.
But what if
why
you haven't made up
your
mind?
I just feel like throwing
why
some small crackers
mind?
In the middle of the table
you
and both of y'all just start eating them.
I hear
wait a minute, Monique, do you agree with her or do you disagree?
And you want to do something, why do you say, what do you want to do? Why don't you say, I want to go to the movies?
Thank you.
Movies,
all right, fair enough. Why don't women just go, I want to go to the movies, instead of going, what are you doing tonight?
Well, sometimes I have the, like, sometimes I'm made
thank you for calling,
mind.
Monique. I almost wanted to leave her on just because she
we're trying to
disagrees
give you
with this asshole. But thanks for calling, sweetie. Hung up
damn.
On her. Sorry, Monique.
Thank
I'm sorry,
you for
baby.
Calling, Monique.
Thank you, Buttercup. We're going to go with somebody who disagrees. Anybody? Ooh, delicious. That's delicious. Wait, you know what we're going to do? We should go to a break. Yeah, man, we've been on a while. Shit, y'all. And you think we're moving? We're going to figure this show out. Are we moving faster with the calls now or no?
Yeah, we definitely are moving faster than last time.
Last time, yeah. Right? I swear I want to learn this call shit because I like when people call. I don't want to leave anybody hanging. I just want to make sure you just get out there. But we're going to get to you. All right, we're going to take a little break, and we're going to get back to you guys in a minute. All right.
It's Black Phillip with Patrice O'Neill.
It is almost better than... When a guy eats your pussy.
What the fuck are you talking about, bitch? And Dante fucking just becoming good buddies. Karis sitting on Dante's lap. It's just a big happy family when Patrice goes away. You traitor motherfuckers. Kiss her neck. Telling her it's all radio. It's fucking bastards. You really are a good fucking cop, bad cop. Dante really does. This fucker really. After I take a swing at him, Dante goes, hey, man. You know, it is terrible you did take a swing at the baby. Come here. Did he hit you? Come here. As he's a worse motherfucker than me. People don't even know it. I want everybody to know Dante ain't shit.
dad is loving us. Come here, Kara.
Yeah,
okay.
It's all right. You're doing great kissing her on her cheek while I'm taking a shit. I love that commercial. That's the best commercial. I'm a man. A manly, manly man. You know, it's like, I want to just go take a dump and they're in here going, no, 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 Pudding Pop, come here. That fur coat you got, that's beautiful. Why did Patrice say it ain't shit? He's so mean. And Dante likes wearing shit that girls... Oh, my God, is that a rattlesnake? Is that a rattlesnake tail?
I was about to say that.
Really? See, this nigga here, he really... This nigga wears... He wears bones in his ears. You know, the nigga took his own eyeballs out and put in, like, it's dolphin eyes or something.
It's his hook.
And then, oh, my God, is that an actual cup of scorpion poison?
Yeah, baby, but you're drinking and shitting right there. It'll, what it does is clean out your,
that's what I call,
ugly system. Get the fuck up, you.
That's what I call the peacock.
This fucker's wearing, this nigga has on a rattlesnake tail.
He does. It's hot.
Fuck are you, Chief Little Hawk nigga? Fuck is wrong with you?
This is my grandfather's.
That's the bullshit, nigga. I swear to God. That's what a nigga do. He go, why you got a bald head? I got cancer. And then fuck up everything.
Well, nah, my mom gave me this. It was my grandma. My mother is Sioux Indian, half Sioux Indian. Swear to God.
You have to turn it into actual...
Well...
Actual...
Now, I want to... But I want to say this.
That's fascinating.
Exactly.
And
nigga's
that
like,
is the point.
Nigga.
Because I only bought this from a novelty store. Stupid.
Uh-huh, goofy. And I knew that. Ain't no real rabbit. That's why the niggas used to wear African pendants walking around. I was so happy when that shit was a style, African pendants, and I could just walk around and look good. Like, I'm from the Ogunga tribe, and this nigga here with a rattlesnake tail.
Let me tell you something. You always talk about the animal kingdom, the peacock. How does a peacock get the female peacock?
He shows them extra bullshit.
He makes pretty. Exactly. He makes
fly
pretty.
With all the colors, the feathers.
And she was all into it. Look at you. Dante got so many. You know what? He's smart. He got so many unorthodox horseshit charms on his neck. Like, what is this? Oh, my God. It's a rattlesnake. It's the rattlesnake that killed my great-great uncle Jim. And I choked it with my bare hands. You choked a rattlesnake? Then you got to Google. Bitches are too dumb to Google. Length of time rattlesnake lives.
Rattlesnakes live
for a week and a half. How'd you kill the rattlesnake that killed your great-great-grandfather? Killed him yesterday.
I'm usually fucking by then.
And fucking it. After you come in the face, you go... I stung you, bitch. Bitches are so goofy. This nigga just told you want this? Nigga got six. Nigga got six rattlesnakes. And he wears a shark tooth on Thursday. Nigga's awful, man. All right, man. We're going to come back to call. Hey, Bob from Pittsburgh, man.
Oh, my goodness.
Bob.
What's up?
How are you, sir?
Good, good.
How's the family? What, nigga? Come on, Bob.
Tell your story.
What's up, man?
What's up? Not much.
Okay.
All right.
Come on, awkward.
Come on,
talk to me.
We got like 15 minutes.
Yeah,
left.
Man. Go ahead, man.
My bad, man. I'm just a little high. I'm calling because I was dating this girl for 2.5 years,
mm-hmm.
and then all of a sudden, she just fucking up and left me for another guy. And now she's still, like, talking to me and stuff
mm-hmm.
and telling me, like I kind of want you back, but I have feelings for him. And then the other day, she told me how much she misses me, but... She's starting to love him now.
Well, there's a name for you. It's called Plan B. And it's a good name.
Yep.
Your name is Bob. You are Plan B for Bob. All right? She's keeping you as a comfort zone.
Break
in
glass.
Case. And let me tell you something, Bob, and I have to move along, but I apologize, and I want to give everybody time. But what she's doing is she's making sure that this guy that taps into her animalism more than you. She's just making sure he's a safe... like haven to leave you for, meaning she knows you're always going to be her little good thing when it comes to like it's okay. So as soon as she feels comfortable that this fucking guy is okay and not a piece of shit, because he is a piece of shit, you know why, Bob? Because she likes him. She likes the guy and loves the guy. He's a dick. That's why you got to start learning how to be a dick, Bob. Just learn it. You can't just start going, fuck you. It's technique. I'm going to tell you what my girl did, and it's very hard. I'm diabetic. People know that shit. Got to take pills. My girl uses my sickness as a way to check on me, as a way to be in my face and a way to be concerned. And it's very difficult for me to say to her, bitch, stop worrying about my health. I can't say that.
Yeah.
So I have to figure out a way to come back because she thinks she found a way to just wiggle into my fucking system where she'll call me if I don't answer. Then she'll call me again. Then she'll call my house. Then she'll call my car, right? Okay, I was worried.
Why can't I just be being concerned? Because we naturally are.
One more thing about her. She was nuts. She's still nuts because if she hears I'm out with, like, other chicks and shit, she'll get all jealous and be like, I thought you loved me and shit like that.
That's
wrong.
She's pimping you.
Dude, that's pimp move number three in the handbook. And she learned it. And the only way she can play that game is because you're her good little thing. You got to take that strap-on dildo out of your booty, and I'm not being mean to you, Bob. It's she's ramming you, and she's fucking you and kissing him. You understand?
Yeah, I know.
She's using you to keep confidence over him because she feels fucked up. You know what she's doing, Bob, if you heard the show?
Yep.
She's dating up. You're her penguin. You're the guy that gives her confidence so she goes back to the male shark and he goes, where you been, bitch? That's what you are. You're a little bitch. And I don't, that's it.
Aww.
Hey, Bob, it is what it is. See you later, buddy. Let me go to Josh in Ohio. Josh?
Yo.
What up, Josh?
What's up, Tree?
Nothing much.
Hey, man. I gotta just tell you, man, everybody out there, that everything you're saying, man, all the points you're making is fucking true. That's for real. I've been with my girl for 8 years.
Josh, are you high?
Leave him alone. Let him fucking. I don't give a fuck if he's retarded. You let him get his praise out. Go ahead, Josh. Finish praising me.
Come on.
Thank you. Charlie from Tennessee, man. Oh, jeez. This one's going to be. This is not going to be good. Charlie?
Yeah, go ahead.
You there, Charlie?
This is Charlie.
All right, this is Patrice O'Neill, Charlie, on the show.
Shit.
What's up, Mr. P?
Hey, man.
I want to know what's up with all these women cheating on all their husbands getting shot up in Iraq, because that happened to me.
Oh,
holy
no.
Shit, your what? Wait, your girl is fucking, now let's be honest here, Charlie. Let's just ask you a question. We have to be fair. Was you getting some of that third world hooker pussy out there? Be honest.
Negative.
No, you was being right to her. That's fucked up, dude. So how'd you find out? She left you for the dude?
No, when I come back, which was earlier than expected, I found a guy in the bed.
Wait a minute. You came from fucking dealing with these filthy Arabs, came home and found a motherfucker. So you came on some old surprise visit shit?
I had an eviction notice on the door, an empty bank account, and everything of mine gone, and cocaine on the table. She was spending all of my combat money on drugs and her boyfriend. God. I was gone.
Now, let me ask you, you're not calling, first thing, you're not calling from jail and no shit like that, right?
I've never been in jail in my life.
But I'm saying, you didn't, here's what I'm saying. I'm giving you complete credit for not putting a fucking,
two hot ones in the cabbage.
Right?
What's that prison?
Two beans in the cabbage.
For putting an Abu Ghraib on these motherfuckers. So you kept your composure and you didn't do nothing harmful to them.
No, thank God I don't have a couple bullets lined up, but.
Fuck me.
Don't do
How
that.
Long ago was this, man?
Don't do that.
Yeah, I got.
Charlie, how long ago did this happen?
This happened 4 years ago.
How long were you in Iraq at the time?
I was in Iraq for 3 years. I was over there from the beginning.
You still hurt 4 years ago and shit. So, have you seen her? Have you heard from her? Nothing.
She won't let me see my kid or anything, no.
Oh, you got a kid with this bitch. This is hard. This is a tough one. I don't know what to do.
Can you talk to her in-laws, to your in-laws, to her parents?
No.
First thing, you got to, did you file for custody with the kids?
They had my rights taken away in absentia by the judge.
Oh, because you weren't there.
I wasn't there, yeah.
Holy shit. What? Wait a minute. Why is she saying she fucking did this shit?
I think he can refile.
He can refile because he's back.
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
You know, Dante knows about some shit because he knows some. Because Dante's like a. He's a dad, but it's not his kid, right?
Yeah.
So, but he raised him, so he knows a lot of this shit. You can refile again.
I think you can file now that you're back.
Now, why is she saying that she did this shit to you?
She's a piece of shit.
She had no reason.
She's just a fucking bitch.
And if she's coked out.
Yeah.
Dude, I don't know what to do about the kids.
I think you can, I think you can refile now that you're back. Are you working now?
No, I'm a disabled veteran.
Do you have a place that you're staying or no?
Yeah, I have a place I'm staying.
How many kids you got?
That one. That's it.
Just one. Do you have a place that you can accommodate this kid?
Oh yeah, I have a 180-acre farm.
Okay, well then you.
Wait a minute. Does he want the kid though?
Yeah, like he wants the
kid. So you want your kid?
I definitely do not want my little girl around a crack.
Around that shit.
Not.
Okay, you
not.
Can then you can file you if you're back and you have a stable place, you can refile now that you're back. Did you try to do that?
I didn't know I could.
Yeah, you can after the absentia you can refile now that
even
you.
If gotten the custody and the name changed and everything?
You can still file. You can there, no.
You're still legal.
No court is gonna not allow you to see your kids if you're what's his name? How long have you been back? Since you've been back?
I've been back about a year.
So last year you found this bitch in the bed with the dude and the coke.
Yep.
Okay, you can refile. You can definitely refile because no court is gonna not. Allow you to see your kids.
Does the nigga have proof?
He's a veteran.
Yeah, that's what I was going to ask. Do you have proof?
She's a junkie and all that shit?
I want to know how I'm going to get all my money back. She spent all $80,000 on my
You ain't
back.
Getting that no, back, man.
That
you ain't getting that back, motherfucker. You might as well drop that. But do you have proof that she's on coke and all that shit?
Oh, hell yeah.
You get your kids if you really want your kids. But here's the thing I would say, dude. I'm going to tell you. Here's how you cannot operate, and this is some of your fucking army training shit. This is just you cannot operate on an emotional level with this, man.
Right.
Because you will kill yourself.
Right.
It's just like
somebody else.
It's just right. It's just like in the army where you over there in Iraq, and I know that some people take it personal.
Yeah.
Like when you're shooting at people, motherfuckers shooting at you, and sometimes you want to go be fucking raghead and kill them, but you just can't do that.
Yeah.
You got to go into whatever operation fuck this hoe.
Right.
And take a deep breath, and you take because you got time. You don't work. You're disabled. Yep. You got time to get this shit right. You do it right. Don't do it like a vengeance move, dude.
Right.
You do it with righteousness. You understand what I'm saying?
One step at a time.
You understand?
I'll be in the mode of it's business.
And thank you. Mm-hmm. Operation, you're a soldier. Operation, repeat after me. Operation fuck this hoe.
Operation... Fuck this hoe.
Hey, man, good luck, dude. Good luck, man.
Seriously.
I feel for you, man. I really do.
Seriously.
How much time we got left, Danny?
We got about 3 minutes.
3 minutes?
Yeah.
Hey, listen, man. Tell motherfuckers I can't take the call, dude. No more calls today. I'm sorry.
Aww.
I'm sorry, Tim, Christian, fucking Matt. Michelle, Michelle, question about shaving pussy.
And I would have totally
John,
answered that.
John, Jim, yeah. Kyle, because we could get in that forever. You know what? Call next time, man. I'm going to try. You know what, Danny, ain't we trying to put this on more often?
Yeah, I'm trying to do that.
It's like a bi-weekly thing or something like that.
Yeah, you know, everybody.
Because Billy got something coming on next week, right?
Yeah, next week will be
Bobby
Bill Burr,
Kelly.
Yep.
They trying to move us in there, but I mean, everybody who's been listening to the Black Phillip Show,
right.
and if we do it again, of course everybody's gonna listen. I thank you for calling, dude.
Yeah.
We're trying to work out the fact that I like to talk, and you can't help the fact that. That was actually a fucking call that's more important than whether you shave your pussy or not, you selfish bastards. But listen, we gotta do the little couple of plugs. Let me do my plug first. Where's my theme music, motherfucker? I want theme music. Come on,
Danny.
Right,
hang on.
You bastard. No theme music.
That's the 2 minute warning. That's the warning.
All right, listen.
I'll get it for you.
Next week, I'm gonna be. That's what's the date on that? 10th. Oh, okay. February 9th and 10th, Patrice O'Neill, which is me, is going to be a stand-up New York on 78th and Broadway in Manhattan. That's stand-up New York. The number is 212-595-0850. And also, theme music, if we could do it. You bastard. Dante is going to be there.
Yeah.
You know what, Danny? Ah, oh, shit. Yeah. Danny's getting it, dog. Danny's understanding
that's
shit.
That's right.
Oh, shit.
Stand Up New York, the 9th and the 10th. I'm hosting
Patrice. Oh, hosting
Patrice.
That show. He's
I'm hosting
that show.
The show for
so that
Patrice.
So that's Stand Up New York, February 9th and 10th at Stand Up New York, 78 in Broadway, 212-595-0850. And a funny-looking nigga with a beard is the boss over there. Karis, you have anything, sweetie?
Yeah. I'm going to be in Miami, but I'm just doing one
show. Oh, wait, theme music.
Oh.
Go ahead. Go ahead, baby.
Stop.
Where you gonna be, buddy?
I'm gonna be down in Miami this weekend. I'm going down there, but I'm only doing one show on Sunday, so I guess.
Where at though? Where?
I don't remember the name of this like theater complex. Go to my website. Go to my website, karith.com. K-A-R-I-T-H. K-A-R-I-T-H. I will try to have it
and
all up on there.
And you can listen to her on stage without me cutting off her mic.
What?
This is what I think.
I'm
going to
be all over the country.
Drew Boogie?
I ain't got shit. I'm just chilling.
Drew Boogie just chilling with some hoes. And listen, ladies and gentlemen, who listen to Black Phillip Show, support it. Support the ONA virus.
Yeah.
Support fucking Bobby Kelly.
Yeah.
All that. We appreciate it, man. And we thank you for calling. And again, I apologize for anybody I didn't get to, but we're going to try to get you to you next time, sons of bitches. That's it. 4, 3, 2, 1. My ball.
We out of here.